stretching and they touching on me. Ooh, think it's vegetables. Ooh, think it's edible. Ooh, it's incredible. Ooh, ooh, ooh. I smell like bun number 99, section full of fine dimes. Bitches staring at me saying, wow.
Unforgettable. Ooh. Like that King Cole. Gucci berry wine.
I drink till I'm drunk, smoke till I'm high, castle on the hill, wake up in the sky. You can't tell me I ain't fly.
You can't tell me I ain't fly.
I know I'm super fly. I know I'm super fly. The ladies love luxury, that's why they all fuck with me. Out here with the moves, like I invented smooth. You can't tell me I ain't fly.
You can't tell me I ain't fly.
I know I'm super fly. I know I'm super fly. Now watch me fly.
It's my life. I'm on Adderall. I be smelling high tech when I piss. Like it's basketball. I drop 50 pointer on my wrist. It's La Colette, take a pick. I came home and dropped a hit. All these diamonds got me sick. I'm Mac and Spoldy.
Cut it sitting high. I feel like I can fly. So first the dub is crazy. Feel like I can die.
Drink till I'm drunk, smoke till I'm high, castle on the hill, wake up in the sky. You can't tell me I ain't fly.
You can't tell me I ain't fly, baby.
I know I'm super fly. I know I'm super fly.
I know
the ladies love luxury. That's why they all fuck with me. Out here with the moves, like I am gonna smooth. You can't tell me I ain't fly.
You can't tell me I ain't fly, baby.
I know I'm super fly.
I know.
I know I'm super fly.
I know.
Now watch me fly.
Live on Kinetic. Kinetic Radio. We shout to the Twitch crew. Damn, this tune is beautiful, you know.
I find you, I give you all you need. I know what you like. I feel it coming. Diamonds of the essence. I try to teach you, but I need some lessons. I need to give it up.
Damn, I think I'm gonna cry, you know.
Turn me out of my mind.
Shout out to the Kinetic family.
You don't need no other body. You don't need no other body. Only you feel on my body. Only you feel on my body. You don't need no other body.
Say not me, the mess of my mind. And I mean they make you free of the mind. Say your body talk to me nice. Say now my love you didn't need for your life. Yeah, I love no be like. Say yeah, we did together, yeah, day and night. Yeah, if I leave you go by. Yeah, if you leave I go
stroking
by.
Your body, baby. Loving your body, baby. As you're whining your body, baby. So crazy. Loving your body, baby. Girl, you want need to me.
Bye.
inside me. Give me all you need, give me all you need, give me all you, give me all you need, give me all you need, give me all. Make I give you all you need every time.
All tight to Pixie, all tight to Master of Games.
Check.
Thought he was gonna start spitting there, bruv.
My fire's blaze up, dance to the sweat, drip from my neck. As we connect, flow is electric. Now miss a step, can't miss a step. Don't worry, baby, all is correct. All that you want indeed, you will get this music. You feed me deeply, oh yes. No, so you feel it deep, but don't fret. Make me move in the dance, get dark and just step.
Yourself a drink, or grab me a drink, please. Somebody, we're gonna be starting up very soon. Shout out to Mal. It's really weird to go from your bedroom to in here, everyone staring at you. Up, I'm gonna start very soon. Big thank you to everybody for making it out tonight. Yeah, it feels weird, doesn't it? Or is it just me? I don't know, 1 minute you're stuck in your house.
push out your back, put your butt in it. Wanna love ya, but I do not wanna commit. So I then twitch ya with the thought of us. And we dancing up in the corner, feeling for the corner pocket. So I ease you up for just a bit. Buy your drink, your half a sip. Then I tell you we should dip. You're grabbing me close and closer till you get a kiss. Push up your bra to the left, that's right. Now we in the car with a rope brake light. Thinking about that, the leg, the hint, the sex, the whip, the figure for leg lock, then we dip out.
You say, wanna party all day. You say, need it, love it, from me. You say, wanna party all day. You say, need it, so why?
Push out your back, put your butt in it. Wanna love ya, but I do not wanna commit. So I then twitch ya with the thought of us. And we dancing up in the corner, feeling for the corner pocket. So I ease you up for just a bit. Buy your drink, your half a sip. Then I tell you we should dip. You're grabbing me close and closer till you get a kiss. Push up your bra to the left, that's right. Now we in the car with a rope brake light. Think about that, the length, the hint, the sex, the whip, the figure for leg lock, then we dip out.
You say, wanna party all day. You say, need it, love it, from it. You say, wanna party all day. You say, need it, so why waste time? So why waste time? So why waste time? Why waste time?
Boyfriend pissed off, smacking his lips off. The fact my lips are covered in your lip gloss. I say we should dip off, out of here. Talk, speak, share some words, grab a ear. Nah, you can't take off unless you Leo with me. Go swallow your pride and put aside your ego. Man, f- being modest, I'm just being honest. You seem whole cooked in them girls McDonald's, but nah, the beard is off. There's always dipping, they duck the sauce. Rocks on my neck, I don't know the cost. Call out front like the Uber, Uber. We can hop in and you can top 10 the list that I wanted to hop in. List is full, so I'ma call it a night. And you ain't even my type, I'm all bark, no bite. I'm so sorry, waste of time, I waste of time. Why you Dutchie wine, it's whatever. The sweat, it drips upon my sweater. It's hot in here, the outside's better. I'm leaving, leaving, you call me back. It's like emotions receding, let's call it an evening. It's getting desperate.
Why waste time? You say, wanna party all day. You say, need it, love it, from
true. shoes is worth talking about. I let him talk all day, let him fill my brain with fear and pain. Follow it up with a knife for a thing I can grab to solve a problem they create. Check that buys me life. Go to sleep, wake up, do it again. All I see is makeup and diamond rings. I don't know my name without positions. Keep mistaking paper for oxygen, because that's what they teach every time I watch TV. Whatever's on the screen is worth thinking about. I let them talk all day, let them fill my brain with fear and solve a problem they created.
Check, check, check. Woo! You not ready, yeah? Are you ready, yeah? We can't hear you. Why, I said, are you ready? Alright, alright. We're not home yet now, you know. Alright. Please, welcome to the stage, your compere for tonight, Inel Tomlinson!
Keep it going. Hey, welcome to Kinetic Comedy. Hey, say what? Welcome to Kinetic Comedy. Hey,
I can't sing. Put it.
Welcome everybody to Kinetic Comedy. Oh my lord. Oh, long time. This is the first time a lot of you lot have been out of the house, isn't it? I can see a lot of you lot going, don't come near me, bruv, don't come near me. I can see it. Hello, everybody at the back. I can't hear you. I said, hello, everybody at the back. That's better. Everybody in the middle row, say, hey. Everybody in the front, say, yeah. All the guys in the house, say, yeah. Hold on, there's more guys than that. It's just you, isn't it? That's you. All the ladies say, hey! Oh, wow, that's a big ratio, isn't it? There's more ladies than guys. Jenny's like, yeah! Loving it. Well, welcome, guys. Welcome to Kinetic Comedy at Peckham Levels. Wow. Finally, we're out of lockdown. It's nice. Well, kinda. Out of lockdown. You out of lockdown? Kinda. Is this like your support bubble over here? Yeah? Is this the person you've been going away with doing exercise during them times? Yeah. Went to get the vaccination before the vaccination was out. Them things. Got that injection? One of them? Yeah? No? Am I going too far already? Sorry. I'm rusty, innit? What's your name? Kate, everybody say hello to Kate. How you doing, Kate? Kate, who have you brought with you today? It's Raj. Everybody say hello to Raj. Big up man like Raj. Are you two friends, partners? You're on a date.
Yeah.
Yeah, this time.
Busting that Tinder, that Bumble, you know, that Hinge.
Bumble. Wow, what date number is this? It's the first date. Wow. Was this like an app thing or like a friend thing or like friends recommended? Or it was a friend thing. Oh, okay, so you got mutual friends and they set you up. Oh, you were already friends, but then you decided to start dating each other. Okay, how did that decision go? Because like you're friends, innit? You know, just casual, just like, do you want to go to the shops? Yeah, let's go to the shops. Do you want to fuck? Okay. Okay. How long you been friends for? A few years. Okay, like, Raj has been playing it nice, innit? Been playing it nice, plant that seed. I'm going to wait a couple years for that one.
Chess, brother, chess. Man's playing
yeah,
chess.
He's like, yeah, he's playing chess. He's like, yeah, wait. I'll come back to that. Lockdown comes. Oh, no. I'm getting lonely. I need someone to be in my support bubble. Raj steps in. Hey, yo.
Need someone to play chess with.
Yeah. Loving it, Raj. I'm loving it, man. So was this Raj's decision or was this your decision to kind of, you know, take the first step and, you know, make this, you know. You made the first move? Obviously. How did he do it, okay? How did Raj approach his first date? Wined and dined, okay. Yeah. Raj took her to the planting place over there, innit? He goes, come on, I know a place that does good jollof rice, yeah? Some planting, yeah, everything nice, there's comedy next door. And Kate was like, yeah. I love planting. Planting a plantain. Oh, hey, we let her decide this. Kate? Ah, Raj, planting a plantain, bro. You hear the audience, Raj? It's planting, isn't it?
Yeah.
You see it there. Aurie, where is it? Well, welcome to the show, guys. Welcome to the show. Couple of things before we begin with the comedy. We are live on Twitch. We are live on the front page. So there's lots of people watching the show. So make sure you know, big this show up, you know, make lots of noise so they can hear you, so we can pick it up on the microphones, because they can only hear your laughter from this mic here. So all them people at the back, I want to hear them big belly laughs, innit, so it can pick up the tape. No, that's a chuckle. Big belly laughs, I can pick up the tape. Aye, not too fake, get it? Come on. Come on, the sponsors are watching. Come on. We're also raising money for Crisis UK. If you don't know the charity Crisis UK, Crisis, they do fantastic work to help eradicate homelessness in the UK. So if you guys are watching live on the stream, you can please donate, !donate in the chat, and it'll pop up a link so you guys can help donate and raise some money. So far, we've raised £100 so far, and the show is only just started. So a big round of applause for that. Can we hit the next goal, though? Can we hit the next goal? 250. Who thinks we can make 250 by the end of the night? Yeah? Oh, guys, by the way, this is Mama T over here. Say hello to Mama T. Any of you lot misbehave, she's the one that kicks you out. Yeah? Mama T is the one. Also, big up DJ Diamond on the decks that has been entertaining you guys. That was fantastic tunes. There he is, right there. With the fantastic t-shirt. Show everybody, Diamond. Show everybody. Tory lives cost lives. Yeah, they are. Yeah, they do. Also, don't forget, we got Marcus over here, over on the projections. Give a round of applause for Marcus as well. Got the whole team here. Big up Melly and Gelly over there on the cameras as well. Working well hard. Don't forget Kyron over there, Mr. Roma. We call him Mr. Roma. You know, Kyron's my nephew, you know. He's my nephew, yeah. This is the whole family thing. We got brothers, we got moms. Yeah, there you go, your son over there. There we go. I'm big up Olivia as well, obviously. Obviously. Some of you guys, I get it. Some of you guys are nervous. It's the first time you've been out in a long time and you don't know how to behave, some of you. It's cool. This is one of those events, right? Hear me out. This is it. I just want one thing to happen for today, yeah? One thing.
want you guys to make me a promise, right? I want you to forget about all the trials and tribulations that you may or may not have had this week, this month, this year. Yeah? This 2 years. Yeah? And for the next 3 hours, I want you guys to relax, enjoy yourselves, and have a good time. Can you guys promise me that? Yeah. I mean, I said, can you guys promise me that? Yeah. That's right. All right, hold on.
You know what, bro?
I'm
a bit disappointed, you know?
I'm looking, I see a couple people's faces at the back. Like, look at that lady there.
Do you know how long I've been sitting on the sofa?
Look,
gotta come better than that.
I know, guys. This lady looks like she's just staring into the abyss. What's going on, Batman? Bring them down the front. I don't even know if she thinks I'm talking to her. Yeah, you. Yeah, the one screaming at you. Yeah, no, behind you,
Mum,
babe.
Has
behind
spoken.
You.
Mum has spoken.
Yes. Yeah, the one that's taking a swig now with the wine. Yes, you. Yes. The one with the screw face going. What's going on, babe? What's happening? I can't hear you. You're going to have to come to the front. You're going to have to come to the front. I can't hear you. I can't hear you back down there. Give her a round of applause. Why aren't you moving? Hold, you think you're safe down there at the back, innit? Did I not just tell you about Kyron? Kyron, go find her, please. Show her to the thousands of people that watching
find
on the
her,
live stream.
A lot of people
since watching. she don't wanna come to the front, we'll go to her, innit? That's, we can do that. We got the facilities.
Couple thousand people watching.
Couple thousand. There you go. Yeah, there she is. The one that's looking a bit shook. Yeah, that one, yeah, her, yeah, the one that's crying. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Don't make her cry. Don't make her cry, guys. Come on, supportive. Supportive. Yeah. Look at this peer pressure. She was like, I did not come out the house for this. What's your name? You're going to have to shout it, Ray. Come on. Rachel. Everybody say hello to Rachel. Rachel, what's been happening, girl? Why you got a screw face on at a comedy show in front of thousands of people? What's happening? Rachel, you're gonna have to come to the front. Come to the front. We can't hear you. We can't hear you from there. What was she saying? I can't hear the thing. What's that? You're buzzed.
Have you got any more of that buzzed?
Diamond, play her a tune. Let's see if she's buzzed. She said she's buzzed. Let's have a look. Let's have a look.
Yo, watch what? Clean people,
okay.
Yeah.
What?
Everybody.
Hey.
Check out
what?
The fresh.
Hey. Butter. What? Rachel. Right. Hey, look at her. Look at her. Look at her. Look at her. Guys, what's happened to Rachel? What's happened to Rachel? Rachel, who are you with today? You're with your roommate. Roommate, what's your name? Alan. What's going on with Rach? What's happened? You don't know? She's married. Oh, she's American. Okay. Same thing, I don't know, you know what I mean? like this is what I wanna do, right, guys? Cause you might be new to Kinetic Comedy, Rachel, but here at Kinetic Comedy we make noise, we dance, we have a good time, we vibes. Yeah? Ain't that right, everybody that's been before? Yeah. All the people that have been to Kinetic Comedy make some noise. That's right, that's right. We need you guys to be energetic and bring the love so we can bring your comedians onto the stage and entertain you and have some fun. We're going to have all sorts of comedians on. We're going to have some games. We're going to have competitions. And we're going to raise some money for Crisis UK. It sounds like a fantastic night. It is like a fantastic night. I just need you to be involved. Are you involved, Rachel? You're nodding. Let's see it then. Diamond.
Daddy Biggs.
Oh, watch go on, Rachel. Hey. Hey, everybody, go on, Rachel, pop them shoulders, pop them shoulders. Hey, come on, Rachel, give us some, come on, guys, give encouragement. Give encouragement. Everyone, give it. Hey, lock it. Diamond, the white girl ain't got no rhythm. She couldn't find the beat. She couldn't find the beat. She couldn't find it. It's a shame, it's a shame. Look, I'll tell you what, Pixie. Look, see Pixie here? Pixie, come show her how it's done. Come to the front, girl, come to the front. This girl knows, what? Come on, Rachel.
I'm all right. It's a bit, make some noise for Pixie, guys. What? All right. Make some noise for Pixie. Okay.
Look at us. All right. A little something. Not a lot.
Wow. Uh-huh. Save some for later, you know, Pixie.
Pixie, come. Sit down, you know. Make a round of applause for Pixie.
Save some of that for later, Pixie.
You see it there, innit? You see it there, Diamond. Right. I'm ragging on. As I said, we got some fantastic comedians coming up for you today. You guys are going to have a lot of fun. I just need you guys to just be involved, engaged, and have a nice time. You guys ready for that? Yeah. I said, you guys ready for that? Yeah. Hey, Darcy, why are you looking this way and you say you're ready? You ready? Yeah. Yeah? All right then. All right. So what I want you guys to do is I want you to start a round of applause off from this side. It's going to spread all the way around. It's going to come all the way over this way. Can you do that for me? Let's do it then. Here we go. Raise even higher. And welcome to the stage, Russell Hicks.
Thank you, Inel, for drastically overestimating my height. I really appreciate that. I don't know how to take that. Was that like some sort of like comedy hazing right there? You just sort of like shoot it all the way to the roof so that I feel just a little bit bad about myself before I start my set? I'm a small man, Inel. Self-esteem hanging by a thread, it's all I can handle. How do we feel about this lighting? I think we can agree, if you were on a date and went back to a guy's flat and it was lit like this, you would leave immediately, right? Who is it? What 70s porno star is in charge of lighting this room right now? I mean, I've never done this show and there's cameras everywhere. Are we all just gonna fuck pretty soon? Like, what's... Hey, have you ever been to Peckham Levels after dark, my friend? Oh, it gets pretty sexy, bro. The lighting, you can't believe. Cameras everywhere, it's all filmed. It goes out on Twitch. I mean, is that what Twitch is? I don't know. I'm 37 years old. Is that what the kids are doing on Twitch? Oh, I hope that the kids aren't doing it. For God's sakes, I hope that's not what's happening. This is great, man. What were you were pointing to that guy back there. You're in charge of lighting this? Yes, you, all right. I'm not gonna lie, man. That table looks like the kind of hipsters that would have a job like that. Like, I do retro lighting for live events. What? Yeah, it's just all retro lighting. It's just various, you know, bad colors, really. I like it, man. You don't look so much like a porn star as you do an avid watcher, if I'm honest, sir. No offense. Watching enough porn doesn't make you a star. I like your attitude. I love the idea of a guy who thinks that if he watches enough porn, he's like, yeah, I'm star status now. I have a subscription, and if you watch a certain amount of hours consecutively, you're considered a star. That's the plan I'm on. I like your style, man. Good table back there, man. I feel like you guys are Peckham. Can you even hear? I know that the sound in the back is absolutely horrendous. I would take that personally if I were you people. Somehow I'm communicating. I would walk out if I were you too. That's probably a good move. I wouldn't go over there. That man's a pervert. Watch out. That man is a known pervert. We've discussed it. If you need any proof, he lit this venue right now. If there's any question as to how much of a pervert that man is. This is what I love about England, is I am just relentlessly teasing you. There's no reason for it, and your friends could not be more excited about it. I'd say by the third time I called you a pervert, the American in me was like, that's a bit much, Russ. Pull it back, all right? And your friends around you were like, go deeper. I'll give you detailed information. What's your email? I'll send you some dirt on this guy. Ruin him. You live in local? Peckham? Porn star? No? Huh? No. What? In case anybody was wondering how bad the sound in the back is, I asked him where in Peckham, and he said porn star name. So that's how that traveled. Sure. You know what? Let's go with your answer. I was going to ask you a boring question about where in London you live, but you've decided to bring out your porn star name. What is your porn star name? Don't act like you don't have one. Listen, mate, we all know that you have a porn star name, you know, because I don't know how old you are, but I imagine that it was still a dream you held on to until about 6 months ago. You were like, you know what? It could still happen. If this graphic design doesn't work out, I think I'm gonna get into the... Of course you're a graphic designer. I better move around the room because I'm killing your table but doing terribly with the rest of the room, man. I think it's the visual. Can we get a camera on that guy? Seriously. I think if you see his face with my teasing, it really helps to elevate it. Yeah, what would your porn star name be, man? What would it? Do you want to be successful in the adult film industry? Something to do with being ginger? I'm not clicking on that, mate. I'm not. Oh, you walked back in at a weird time. We were currently discussing what this guy's porn star name would be, and he said that it would be something to do with being ginger. I suggest that's possibly not the best route to go. I don't know that that's a subgenre on the hub that I would be clicking on regularly, my friend. And when I say hub, you know what I'm talking about. You know damn well what I'm talking about. I do love this area though, man. This is proper, like, this is the real hipster rabbit hole, this area, isn't it? You know what I mean? This is where people can get, you can get really lost, you know? Peckham levels. This is where you'll see somebody ride by, like on a penny farthing, you know, with like a top hat and a monocle. And just like, and then it's always those types of hipsters that deny they're hipsters. Do you ever notice that? I'm not a hipster. I'm like, you're not even wearing shoes. Those are baked potatoes, okay? You're gone, man. You're off the scales. But that's the price living in London. That's the beautiful thing. It's a metropolitan city, very liberal city. That's what I love about London, right? Very liberal place to live. There's a trade-off, though. If you've ever lived in a big city, London, anywhere, the trade-off is that the people are extremely liberal, but they're assholes, right? That's the trade, man. People have amazing views. Oh, all organic, fair trade. But you see them walking around, they're freaking elbowing you in the ribs, tossing you in the street, little old ladies throwing them in the road. Just get out of my way, Agnes. I gotta get to Boots. Oh, please move. And then you ask them, what do you support? Yes, everything, LGBTQ, all of it. I had to just, that little old lady was in my way. I've gotta get vape liquid. But the trade-off, if you go outside of London, right? If you go to like somewhere like Kent or something, you will meet the nicest racists you have ever seen. They are the nicest people with the most horrible political opinions. And that's the trade, man. What are you gonna do? I don't know. What is with people that didn't want to wear masks, by the way? Like, what was that whole thing about? I don't get it. People who didn't want to wear masks. I don't want to. Nobody wanted to. It's not like I like it. I'm sure there's like one weird person that was actually my lips get cold in the winter. Maybe that guy wanted to wear it, okay? Nobody else wanted to. I'm talking to my parents back home in America, and they've become like, for some reason my parents have become like complete conspiracy theorists, like gone off the rabbit hole, like totally gone, right? They're like, Bill Gates is trying to put the vaccine in you to get nanobots in your butt and all that shit, right? My parents are like, the government can't make me wear a mask, Russ. the government can't make me wear a mask. I'm like, listen, Dad, you know the government tells you what to do every day of your life, right? Like, you ever notice you can't walk into the grocery store with your dick out singing happy birthday to yourself? That's the government that makes that a possibility, okay? We wear masks over our bits every day. They're called pants. I don't think it's much of a stretch we start covering our lips for a little bit. I think there should be more laws like that. I don't think British men should be able to take their shirts off in the summertime. Yeah, it's been a long winter. Nobody wants to see those pasty tits. You seen these guys out in the common? Where do they get the body confidence? Dear fat, pasty white men, put it back on. You haven't earned this. You gotta put in the work the 11 other months out of the year to earn that summer. If I was in America, I would have said 9 months, but your summer is like 2 weeks long. The sun only comes out once in a while. That's why you guys lose your fucking minds when it comes out. Because it comes out and then it's raining again? What the hell is that shit? This weather is gaslighting me. It's putting me on edge, ginger porn star. Nobody has ever sat down, opened their laptop, and said, I'm in the mood for a ginger guy. A ginger girl? No. I want the man to be ginger. And I would like the lighting to be tacky, if possible. What you talking about? Out of curiosity. Some people do actually like ginger men. That's actually a good point. You're right. I was being, some women like ginger men. You're in the wrong section, my friend. It turns out this ginger porn star idea has got legs. I don't know what I was thinking. It's a good thing I'm not in any important position in the adult film industry. Right up here, they're into ginger men. Are you into ginger men? No, not you. That was an emphatic no, my friend. I said, are you into ginger men? Couldn't even get the sentence out. She went, no. Unbelievable. Are you laughing at me or whatever you're looking at on your phone right now? That's one of the best things I've ever seen, just someone enjoying their phone in the front row. I'm not gonna stop you. I mean, any laughter at this point is welcome. But I've never had the experience of looking at somebody, and look, more distractions. Good for you. Boy, well, that's perfect timing. Now you've got your phone, a little snack. Who needs me? I hope I don't bother your meal and TV time. I'll just be standing here under the worst lighting I've ever experienced in my life. What are you laughing at on your phone? Are you watching ginger porn? What? Apparently they are the best. Holy shit, man, this is really starting to spread. I think by the time you get out of here, people are actually gonna believe it. Hey man, you make a lot of money in the porn industry? Yeah. Anyway, man, cool. Right on. You got your phone going too. What are you looking at? I'm just curious. Honestly, I've been locked up for, 12 months. Just any interaction is. What's that? You're looking to get some food. Do you order it? Oh, you order it here. You order it on the app? Oh, okay. Sorry about that then. I forgot that. I thought you were just like on Uber Eats. All right, ma'am. Cool. Got your food? No, I wanted tacos. You wanted tacos? What'd they give you? They gave you some potato things. Unbelievable. Fucking hell. That's not tacos. That's not even close. How do you fuck that up? Let me get some tacos. What? Potatoes? I don't know what you said. I brought you two baked potatoes. I'm assuming this will work. And I'm offended on another level because I'm from San Diego, California, which is like right next to Mexico. We have the best Mexican food ever. Did you know, actually, that it was an American that invented the burrito? Did not know that. It makes sense, actually, when you think about it. Like, just imagine the beginning of the burrito, right? I imagine a Mexican came and had a beautiful spread. You know, I've made you some beans, rice, jalapenos. And some American was like, okay, shut up. Here's what I want you to do, okay? I want you to take all that shit, roll it up, yeah? Roll it up into one big old piece of carpet. I'm gonna eat in one bite, okay? No, no, senor, you cannot do that. You don't shut your mouth, I'll throw you in there too, Jorge. You hear me? Roll it up. There's two things I like in this world. Burritos and ginger pornography. Yeah, you heard me, ginger porn. That's right, some women actually like gingers. I heard that at a show once. These two girls were sitting on the couch. One of them was paying attention, the other one was on her phone for most of the evening. Until their tacos showed up, which turned out to be potatoes. And then her friend walked out, just like she had done earlier in the evening as well. So for anyone keeping track, that's two walkouts within the span of a 10-minute set for this poor bastard. Anyway, you guys, this has been a lot of fun. I've been Russell Hicks. Thanks a lot. See you later. Bye-bye.
Give it up for Russell Hicks! I'm caught up in the lights. That was Russell Hicks there. Oh, my goodness. Oh, just a quick reminder, guys, if you do want to get your drinks, yes, you scan the codes with your phone, and then you can order your drinks from the table, and you can order your food from the table, and they will bring it to you. There you go. Table service. Everybody cool with that? Yeah? Everybody good? You joined yourself so far? Yeah, that's nice to hear. Well, next up, we got a fantastic act. Another Kinetic Comedy favorite, also known as one of my brothers from another, or another mother, don't even know. And as I said, this guy, we go way, way back, and I know you guys are going to love him. So I'm going to need you guys to give him a big, proper Kinetic welcome. Darcy, I need you to... Can you start off this round of applause for our next comedian, please? I want you to stand up, because we've got Johnny coming on. I want you to help introduce him, because obviously we've got some sound issues at the back. Some people can't hear at the back, so you're going to be my mediator, bro. I'm going to tell you what to say, and then you tell the people behind you what I'm saying. Yeah? All right. You might have to stand up. They can't see you, bro. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Listen. Listen up. Everyone listening. This next act. Bro, relay the thing. This next act. Is incredible. That's right. All right. He's gonna lick the roof off. Yeah? Fire hazard, this guy. Yeah? Earthquake are coming. So I want you guys to make enough noise. And welcome to the stage, Johnny Cochrane.
Love it. I am here to lick the roof off. Oh, yes. You know it. Right, I'm going to crack on. Hello to everyone who's seen me here before, but I've got lots to talk about. A lot of shit's happened over the last year and a half, hasn't it? So one of the things that's been grabbing my attention is basically there's quite a lot of racists that are getting really angry, right? And then when you question it over it, they pretend that it's not because they're racist that they're angry, it's other shit, right? And I'll give you an example. The first time I think it started happening was, do you remember when Diversity done that Black Lives Matter dance, right? Yeah, you remember that, yeah? And then there was a record amount of complaints to Ofcom. And they started going, no, it ain't because of what they're saying that I'm mad about. It's just family viewing. You shouldn't mess with our shit, okay? No, well, I don't care what they're saying, but it's family time. Britain's got talent. This is not Britain does politics. If anything, it should be Britain's not political. You can short it to be an MP. I don't care. All right, just don't make it political, for goodness sake. And the thing is whenever things like this happen, right, one thing I always do is I go on the Daily Mail website, I read the story, and then underneath I read the comments to see how the right-wing average man is dealing with this, right? And there was one comment that grabbed my attention, right? This one guy was like, diversity got a fucking cheek. How many white dancers they got in their troupe, eh? Genuinely, I mean, right, in this man's mind, that he genuinely believes the biggest issues facing racial dynamics in this country, there's not enough opportunity for white dancers. You know what I mean? He's probably been at a house party with his mate Barry in the corner, just like, like, you're the nuts for dancer, Barry, you just need an opportunity, son. Hey, you'd be great in that diversity, but they're too fucking politically correct to give you a chance. It's mad. But the fact is that's how we know, right? That is how we know that it's actually not the method that they're annoyed by, it's the message. Another thing that where it came up was when the statues started getting ripped down. Do you remember the slaver statues getting ripped down? The most famous one was Edward Coles, and yes, some claps there, nice, probably people involved in it, actually. Look like they're, yeah, the kind of people who nick fucking little street cones on the way home as well. The most famous one was Edward Colston in Britain, in Bristol, right? He was a famous slaver. Now, people were in uproar. No, you can't rip down our slavers. We want our slaver statues. This guy had a plaque underneath his statue, which spoke glowingly about him. Oh, Edward Colston, the city's most wisest and most generous fellow. He's like, what are you? This guy is a terrorist. That is what he is. You know what I mean? Similarly, Jimmy Savile, the most prolific sexual predator in this country, right? He had a plaque in Leeds. Within a week of finding out about his historical crimes, they ripped it down, okay? There was no one there going, all right, you know, maybe we shouldn't have done it. Maybe we should have, because this was the thing that they said. Why don't we just add a little line, an addendum at the end of his plaque, like, oh yeah, wise and kind fellow, asterisk, was involved in the slave trade. You know, like you could distill his crimes into just that sentence. You wouldn't have that with Jimmy Savile. No one was saying that. No one was saying, I'll leave Jimmy's plaque up, just add a little line at the end, you know what I mean? Yeah, Jimmy loved the fun run. Oh, yeah. He was great on the decks, he was. Yeah. He'd go out of his way to fix it for anyone. Yeah. Asterix, he shagged the odd corpse. You know, you wouldn't... Okay, I'm putting it out there. Now, the other thing, the most recent example of this, right, is the uproar around players kneeling, football players kneeling. We've seen it all, right? And they're coming out here and they're being like, no, I don't think they should be doing it, it's all wrong. Nigel Farage, racist in chief in this country, right? He comes out and he says, do you know what? I don't think they should be kneeling because they're secretly doing it as part of a Marxist ploy. Does this guy genuinely think, right, that the new vanguard of the neo-Marxist movement in this country are millionaire footballers? Do they really think that after a game they're going to be like, oh, I'm here with Harry Kane. Harry, you scored a hat-trick today, you won 3-0, you must be delighted. No, not really. And I won't be until the proletariat rise up and reclaim the means of production and thus reshape society along more egalitarian means. Thus ending capitalism. Now, if you'll excuse me, Dele Alli's throwing a party at China White's and there's page 3 models everywhere. Viva la revolution! It's not gonna happen. Okay, now don't get me wrong, there are some, you know, kind of legit criticisms around the whole kneeling situation. Some people think that it's kind of lost its effect. I don't agree with them. Some people think it's a bit tokenistic. But it wouldn't be the first time we've done tokenistic stuff that's been attached to a political cause. Do you remember when we used to wear wristbands, like little blue wristband anti-bullying? Do you remember that? Right, well, I thought about this recently because there's a story attached to it. I used to have an anti-racism wristband, and after I did a gig, it was actually a Kinetic Comedy at the last venue, right? I went to the toilet after my set, and a white guy followed me in, right? And as I'm weeing, a guy goes, "Like your wristband, mate." Now, I found it a little disconcerting because that wristband was attached to the wrist of the hand that I was holding my penis with at the time. I'm like, yeah, checking out. Anything else you like down there, for goodness sake? He's like, yeah, I really like the wristband, right? And he goes, I need to buy one of them. Where'd you get it from? Now, I kid you not, right? His reason for why he wanted one will stop you in your tracks. It certainly did me. This is genuinely true, right? He went, I need to buy one because I've just been charged with racially aggravated assault. and I want to show the judge I'm not a racist. Like, that's not how it works, mate. You know, you're not going to be in court standing in front of a judge and he's going to be like, you're Tommy, they're all called Tommy, you've been charged with racially aggravated assault. How do you plead? Oh, how do I plead? That's a tough one. Judge, introducing Exhibit A. And the judge is like, there must be some mistake. I've just found out a bit of this exculpatory evidence. He said, no, we'll get rid of the racial charge. How about we'll just give you a plain old assault. Exhibit B, anti-bullying. Okay, you're out of there, Tommy. It's fine, just get out. But once again, it's not the method that they have a problem with. It's the message all the time, guys. That's it. So what else about race as well? So basically, I'm actually going to move it on a little bit, because one of the other things that was a bit of a racial hotspot this last year was when there was an explosive interview with Meghan and Prince Harry. Did we all see that, people? Yeah, exactly. A lot of people got angry about that. And in the explosive interview, Meghan and Harry revealed that one unnamed member of the royal family brought up the conversation point where they questioned how dark Archie's skin might be. Now, I'm not going to hazard a guess at who the member of the royal family was that's actually said that. I mean, he's dead now anyway, so there's no point in, you know, going through that. But, yeah, but in general, you know, this whole notion about whether or not a child can pass or not, this is nothing new. This has been going on for generations, guys. It really has. And I have the same thing. I've got a little one-year-old son, and I have the same thoughts about whether he can pass as well. But not pass as a white person in society. I have issues about whether he could pass as my son. That's the thing. I start thinking, because I've had a child with a white lady, right? And I just think about us going down for walks, you know, on the street. And I just don't want people looking at us as a family, looking at my white wife, looking at my one-year-old who looks kind of white, looking at me, then looking back at my wife and think, fucking hell, she moved on quick, didn't she? we don't need it. But I'm always about like making my son feel connected to his black heritage. I want that, do you know what I mean? Like, I'm always putting like cocoa butter on his skin. Like, come on, he's got to learn, you know what I mean? I'm putting oil in his hair, and whenever like he has a play date or anything, I make sure he turns up late to that shit, okay? Learn about the culture, son, learn about it. But, you know, the other point, I'm going to move it on, because something else that's been going on, apart from all the racial dynamics over the last year, is we had a pandemic. That was mad, wasn't it? And I'll tell you what, the whole COVID issue has made me more cynical. Like, the other day, I was walking through the park with my son, right, and some old geezer was holding a couple of balloons. My son is obsessed with balloons. He's just staring at them like, oh, yeah. And this guy, he was being kind, right, and he was like, he can have it if you want. But I'm just sitting there like, you probably blew that up yourself, didn't you, mate? Let's put a hold on that little COVID grenade that you're about to hand over to my son, don't you? Want me to take that into my living room, do you? Just fucking being let off with all your spores at its leisure, no, mate? No. Don't want your COVID grenades, thank you. Not interested. But in general, right, so one of the other things that we've been tested with regards to COVID is before the vaccine, certainly, you know, we all had to almost self-diagnose if we thought that we had COVID. I'm sure you've all done it at one point, like, yeah, I think I got it this time, yeah, I do. But it was hard, wasn't it, guys? It was hard because some of the symptoms around COVID were exactly the same as a hangover, weren't they? Yeah, or even worse, a come down. Like, I don't know this, but I'd imagine that there were people at the driving centre, at the walk-in test centre, just turning up in their car like, you all right, mate? Fucking hell, I think I've got the COVID. Been up all night, mate, yeah. Sweating, yeah. Can't get it, yeah, need a test, mate, yeah. Need a test. Get it back in a couple of days later. Got my test results back. COVID negative, cocaine positive, okay? last thing as well, I haven't got, you know, got long left, but do you know one thing that's kind of caused me bother around the whole COVID adapting to it? It's like, you know, this having to wear masks all the time. Like, the one thing that it's done for me, like, I know there's a lot of people who are really anti-maskers and stuff like that. I'm not that anti-masker, but in general, one thing it's shown me is how bad my breath is sometimes. Why didn't you guys tell me, for fuck's sake? Some of yous have been suffering in silence. I'm chatting to you. Honestly. Fucking, you want to keep that 2 meters, don't you? Social distance. Honestly, I'm walking around on the street sometimes with my mask on. I think a small woodland creature has come up and died and started to decay. It's my breath. I'm walking around Sainsbury's trying to slow down my breathing, not breathe too much. Just with a mask on, you can't escape. I'm like fucking Darth Vader. Like, it's my breath. It's my breath. Right, that's my time, guys. I've been Johnny Cochrane. If you want to follow me on my socials, I'm at iJohnnyCochrane. That's for you guys on Twitch as well. Enjoy the rest of your night. It's been lovely. Thank you. And bye-bye.
Give it up for Johnny Cochrane. Oh, my word. Oh, my gosh. Did you guys enjoy that? Nice. Well, what we're going to do right now, guys, we're going to have a quick interval. We can go to the toilet, grab some drinks, and do your thing. And then people on the Twitch, don't forget we're raising money for Crisis UK. Hopefully we can get some donations in. And then after the break, we're going to be back with some more games, with some comedy, and some more music. Diamond, let's hear some tracks. And everybody, give it up for all the acts you've seen so far. I see you in 10 minutes.
Just fly. And I said that she want quarantine. What? So when me do me give her the vaccine? Right away. When me do me give her the vaccine? But a girl come from a papa pee. What? And I see her boyfriend I should leave. What? So when me do me give her the vaccine? Right away. When me do me give her the vaccine? She buck up and the man a argue. And the boy now produce the scene. No, no. When me do me give her the vaccine? Right away.
Make the world at all. Step out strong for the summer, yeah.
but strong for the summer. Yeah.
It's time to get ready. Summer is here. Party all night.
Outside, outside.
Yeah, time now for step out with chest out. All I need your palm and the teacher for get let out. And let's party for the rest of this year. I shell the place now without fear. Outside. Dab, plus my buy some new gears.
Lose.
I may have some new ears.
Lose.
I may not save them for Christmas. So me I go party now without fear. Step out strong for the summer, yeah. Not even COVID can flop this a summer, yeah. Tell every hot girl for come, yeah. Cause we stepping out strong for the summer, yeah.
It's time to get ready. Summer
yo, ding
is
dong.
Here.
A step London.
Party all night.
Yo, won't tell them.
I'ma tell the guests in the Bima. Over 9, double figure.
Huh?
Now tell me you a star and you're bitter. Wow. Apple cider vinegar. Any girl with me have a Pablo take. Anytime me go off new whip.
New whip.
You know me style, me no run down bitch. The girl in love me like a makeup kit. Man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star. Even astronauts know me the far. China running for my style, me full of bars. We get scars. Man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star. When me do road over me in the car. Big belly berry happy day in the park.
Chubbing me a star. Gangsta won't put me in a car. Rev out the big body Benz, chrome white SLR. Diamond pon me neck, dem a war. Dem know I'm up, up, up. If I'm milling at the truck, if I'm milling at the cut. Hey yo, ding dong, make them know so we kill some. So the price for the feature for up. Nuff girl say them ready, ever ready from a barn. When me check it out, them not even write them song. Them a rhyme, but the thing nah lick. Rich and famous, rich and famous.
Know me the far. China running for my style, my full of bars. We get scars. Man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star. When me do road over me in the car. Big belly berry off the day in the park. Rich and famous on a stink like sh. Man a star, me no shopping down a flea market. But we get the thing them who no can't find it. For me wife a the artist a true, she private. Top of the Kyle tech. Like gymnastic, make money flip. Come here so with style in your get. Man a star, you know if you like it. Man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star, man a star. Even astronauts know me the fact. China running for my style, my full of bars. We get scared.
Me, stick to me thing. No boy can beat me, no switch to me skin. Kingston Buffy and I mix with the thin man. No in and a skin teething. Them say bad up who? Which part? Which crew? I couldn't meet them a chat amongst you. You can't call me coming up, callaloo. Them say Max in a face. When? Oh, which guy? Me no believe that apply. Bad way, them story they me no buy.
Yo, the one and yet heavy metal. When it beats straight feet and a rose petal. Wet them up, disinfect them like a detal. Me things them in a harder alphabetical. Yo, me want me things them and a rental. Survive gangsta life, no accidental. Out the road, me get me street credential. And me no left me dark, cause that's essential.
Them say bad up who? Which part? Which crew? I couldn't meet them a chat amongst you. You can't call me coming up, callaloo. Them say Max in a face. When? Oh, which guy? Me no believe that apply. Bad way, them story they me no buy.
Me no China run off mode something ya. My face them can't thump in a. Bus one at even bump them bus in ya. Watch man things like a flat screen Toshiba. One chat till we get serious in ya. The things clean if no carry no rust in ya. Wipe them out like the bomb at Hiroshima. Lone disaster. Them say bad up who? Which part? Which crew? I couldn't meet them a chat amongst you. You can't call me coming no callaloo. Them say Max in a face. When? Oh, which guy? Me no believe that apply. Bad way, them story they me no buy.
Yo, that one and yet heavy metal. When it beats straight feet and a rose petal. Wet them up, disinfect them like a detal. Me things them in a harder alphabetical. Yo, me want me things them and no rental. Survive gangsta life, no accidental. Out the road, me get me street credential. And me no left me dark, cause that's essential.
Attent.
Them say bad up who? Which part? Which crew? I couldn't meet them a chat amongst you. You can't call me coming up, callaloo. Them say Max in a face. When? Oh, which guy? Me no believe that apply.
them story, they me no buy.
You really think I went up 3-4 scrum? Like corn on a shh, I could have let in a uni room. But I know better. Us wanna see me get nicked with a shh, but I know better. Next day, shh, I've got back shh. Hang on, cut down to this street that shh. And shh, they should know better. Don't see me in a flesh and don't make man leak. Man do shit for the gram and tweet, man raise that shh and ski. Let's see. Man could have put it on the net when gang done chinged up. And the bros didn't leave her. Man just step into the media. Simple. Shout out to get L and L. Made a W and W. And I think you can get wild. Then no love. No better. S in a finish. Oh, stella. I'm not doing my match. Only got to know that I'm on camera. They want me in a bit. Oh, summer. That would have been for some.
We know him, but whatever. Still
out here,
B. Lost the stake
on
these things.
Odd men's doing up commentary, we forgot that. Then he came on ahead in the mandem, and that's just part that they got. Everybody do it for the net so much, they forget to go do the job properly. Down ching down, put one on the wing, I was playing Monopoly. Still see me on the upper open toe. I could have put sh in the net when I had my crush and I'm crying on toe. And B on the knees, you really think I went up 3-4 scrum? Like corn on a shh, I could have laid in the uni room. Shh, I know better. Us wanna see me get mixed with a shh, but I know better. Next day, shh, got back. Gang done got down to the street. And shh, they should know better. Don't see me in the flesh and don't make my leak. Man do shit for the crap and beat. Man rise that shh and ski. How many? Shh. Let's go. Whip it, set it, blink it, chef it, cop it, chop it, press it, cop it. Sell it, rob it, fly it, drop it, try it. It's there on the man, I supply it. You know the cocaine dying. You know see the gun, then bust. Lean with a gun like Russ. Knowing they dying, they're lying on us. Look up in the yard and I'm flying the dust. Trust, no loyalty, she's lining them up. No royalty, your queen, give it up. Chest that back, I'm beaving them. Up and down, no seesaw. Detour, I use that mean. I got six and if you add three more, then I'm someone who I might get. And I'm tired of seeing the cat. Whole thing, yeah, she love. Got a very phobic. Build on bots like Joshua Shank, game popular. Do my proper shot up. Throw me a box and I got the young man take me to the pounds of boots. My boss, but they have me in the can like Foster. Let's start up. Don't really want me. If he's copying me, some silly and whip it, set it, blick it, shove it, cop it, drop it, press it, cop it, look it, sell it, rob it. Fly it, drop it, try it. It's there on the money, supply it. You know, cocaine diet. Whip it, set it, blink it, shove it. Cop it, drop it, press it. Cop it, look it, sell it. Rob it, fly it, drop it, try it. It's there on the money, supply it. You know, cocaine diet. Spill some juice, K. Okay? And it was a f*** when bros got the 17.
Would you know about branding? Trying to get them six-figure deals in. Heritage plaque for the children. Straps out of blue on the building. Man, I come from the city of God. Man's gotta build this village if it kills them. All my real niggas feel this. Blood, sweat and tears. Man's been out here for years and years. Man's had
5 minutes and we're back.
Man's gotta move past fears. For storming, man shed tears.
Roller. Do this for the culture. Building like a soldier. No time for a vulture.
Shouts to the Twitch crew. Peckham levels. Big shout out to Isla.
It's never done till it's over. Gotta play the game like poker.
My G's done it from a test press. Food even in man express. Man never did Dex yet. And then man never had Dex yet. And Stormzy never had sex yet. Kano didn't even get shit. Tish never got that stretch yet. And Wiley never got vexed yet. And Dizzy Rascal never left yet. Chickmong didn't even wreck yet. JME wasn't spitting with Skep yet. And JK never lost depth yet.
Do this for the culture. Building like a soldier. No time for a vulture. Yeah, I'm trying to be an owner. I'm trying to make 100 bags for my phone. Tryna go hunt like boner. It's never done till it's over. Gotta play the game like poker. Do this for the culture. Building like a soldier. No time for a vulture. Yeah, I'm tryna be an owner. Tryna make 100 bags for my phone. Tryna go hunt like boner. It's never done till it's over. Gotta play the game like poker.
It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. None of them quit, I carry on. Every MC nowadays got a body on. The rose is stress. So I'm at home trying to get my Cali on. Trying to save niggas from Babylon. But all these niggas just Babylon. I got a bank card like a travel.
Alright, guess who's back from the not day, cause I've never been. No one ever said Ness wouldn't get a pen again. Look to the scene, no one is leveling. Then again, you lot seem to be letting them think that they are giving all sorts of titles. That's a part, cause they talk like it's Bible. Whop their ass up, walk up the mic cord. You don't wanna walk, but I'll show you what I do. And I know to some of them I'm new, but I'll win them over. Too many men have been sitting kosher, but this is my thing, I'ma let them know. But some man just shook but gas the artist like, nah, I'm sure you can spin a joker. You don't wanna make that move, nah, cause you don't wanna take that route, car. Just getting rid of my new, but yeah, I'm not kidding, don't know what I might do.
Couple minutes left.
I ain't got nothing to prove when I sit up on a rhythm, but I know I
get yourself seated nice and comfy.
I did choose, I call, everybody's got views. But tell me who goes missing 6 years of school.
Second half of the show starting in a minute.
Better than them, head screwed on now, had in their pen. Some get mad, can't stand it and sin. That's not a good plan, I'll get mad and condemn. Fuck a female, cause have a comment. Hit a panic in them, not gonna have it again. Watch hard work and talented win. But you never catch me in another artist DM. On some please retweet on your TL. That's a big thing on a DL. Know that I'm gonna do my thing, run up and I work hard. Day job in the AM, spit a mad verse since dudes by the PM. Some guys wanna do moves for a BM. And some girls trap them dudes to beat BM like every 2 months. MC's dead but no food once left, so you let them slide. Every 2 months. She looks good on your arm, so you drop out the girl that rides. Every 2 months. Box of food to flip, but you sit and smoke the supply. Every 2 months. I go missing all the time. And some just wanna know why. I found my way back though. Found my way back home. This thing's in my blood, let me make that known. Got lost, but I wasn't gonna take that. No, boom. Straight into payback mode, got focused. Not another me on the road, and I know this. I was wanna see me stay low, but I'm chosen. I've got this, man. Long for the joke team, but you laugh, man. I'm missing, you're only half gone. Talk up, where's all the bars gone? If you're fired, then I wanna see arson. When guards were up, and you couldn't get past them. I stay laughing, cause no one can do what my son does. You boy, I'm old school like £5 subs. But you didn't pay them, and you ain't walked a mile on my pavement. Been a problem from the moment I came in, and I was gone long when my spot's still vacant. Safe then, I'ma roll back and blaze them, cause me, quiet, saves them. Didn't want a light to awaken, but I'm hungry, craving. Still rougher than them, I got my mind right, nothing can bend. Some don't like that cussing them scent. That's not a good move, I'll get rugged on them. Fuck a female straight coming for men. Go and stomach it then. Not gonna plummet again, this time I'm coming to win. But you never catch me in another artist DM. On some please retweet on your TL. That's a big thing on a DL. Know that I'm gonna do my thing, run up and I work hard. Day job in the AM, spit a mad verse since dudes by the PM. Some guys wanna do moves for a BM. And some girls trap them dudes to beat BM like every 2 months. MC's dead but no food once left, so you let them slide. Every 2 months. She looks good on your arms, so you drop out the girl that rides. Every 2 months. Box of food to flip, but you sit and smoke the supply. Every 2 months. I go missing all the time, and some just wanna know why.
Right. Everybody ready? Nearly, kind of. All right.
I still haven't had a drink yet, you know. What's going on in here? Come on, mate. Come on, mate. Get us a drink. Right. Please, for the second half, welcome to the stage your compere, Inel Tomlinson.
Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back to part two of Kinetic Comedy. Welcome, welcome. You guys enjoying yourselves so far? That's lovely. That's lovely. Good to hear. Good to hear. We've got new people on the sofa as well. Big up the new peoples, them. Easy, easy, easy. Oh, she busy. She busy. You busy. Who are you messaging? Everybody. Okay, okay. It's like this. All right. We got competition time now. But before we do that, what's that? Someone's who's taking a selfie over there? You good? All right. I know you guys couldn't hear at the back. Rachel, can you hear now? Can you hear it now? Everything good? Back, you blessed at the back? The back blessed? Sure? Me can't hear you there. Good, 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 good. Right, we got competition time now. We got a fantastic competition we got going. The Kinetic favorite. We're going to guess the tune game. But first, we're going to need two volunteers. So, volunteer your friends. Two volunteers. We need two people to come play this game there. Oh, we got a couple nominations. Is that nomination there? What? What do you mean, which one? He was pointing at you. Okay, okay, okay. Who else we got? Oh, we got the girls on the... Oh, these girls are so on their phone, they're not even in the room. What's going on? What's going on? Oh, we got a couple of nominations at the back. Everyone's pointing at Rachel. Is that Rachel? Is everyone pointing at Rachel? Hey, Gally, let me see the camera. Is everyone pointing at Rachel? Is everyone pointing at Rachel? All right, guys, do we want Rachel to play? Rachel, come redeem yourself, girl. All right, we also need someone else as well. We can't, not just Rachel, we need someone else as well. Oh, we got nomination over here. Oh, bare nominations. Hold on, which one? That table there, we got a table here. This lovely lady. Would you like to play as well? Yeah, come to the front, come to the front. Round of applause. Rachel, you come in. Rachel, what's going on? Okay, okay. All right, we got my man at the back. My man, oh no, wait, he's walking out. Are you coming? Oh no, oh wait. Where you going, bruv? He nominated himself, then he walked out of the room. Well, lovely. What's your name, lovely?
Leah.
It's Leah. Everybody say hello to Leah. There you go, Leah. You could stand over there, Leah, for me. That's it. Thank you. And over here, my brother. What's your name?
Maurice.
We got Maurice as well, guys. Big up, man, like Maurice. Maurice, come over here. Over there. Okay. This is a simple game. Maurice, you're going to be repping this side of the room. Yeah? This side of the room, make some noise. It's the Maurice gang. Gang, gang, gang. This side is Leah's side of the team. Make some noise, Leah's team.
Boy, that sounds a bit wonky, bruv.
It does. Yo, what's going on with Maurice's side? Bruv, you not got no fans? All right, big up Maurice's side. That's a little bit better, a little bit better. You still got a couple girls on their phones not paying attention, but still, it's all good. All right, Maurice, what do you do, my bro?
What do you do? Oh, theatre.
Oh, you're a theatre guy? Yeah. Oh, awesome. Oh, fantastic. Working in the arts? I like that. And Leah, what do you do, my bro? Oh, Leah runs her own business. Okay. Well, this is the rules of the game now, guys. This is the rules of the game. DJ Diamond's going to spin a track. And what I want you guys to do, you need to guess the name of the track and the name of the artist, okay? Once you know both, raise your hand in the air, shout out Kinetic, and then I will come to you for your answer, okay? All right, everyone clear on the rules? You clear on the rules? You clear on the rules, Maurice? You clear on the rules? Okay, now, if it looks like Maurice or Leah ain't got a clue, yeah, you guys can help them out. Okay, yeah, you lot are helping out Maurice's team. If Maurice looks like he don't know what he's doing, then you need to come shout out and help him out, yeah? We good, Maurice's team? Okay, okay, okay. Same on this side. If it looks like Leah don't know her R&B and her hip-hop and all them things there, you help her out. Is that all right, Leah's team? Okay, okay. One question first before we begin. Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Okay. Online chat as well. Online chat, let us know who you think's gonna win as well. Might give out some bonus prizes as well to the online people. Okay. Everybody clear on the rules? Right. DJ Diamond, what's the first track? Oh, what? Maurice, you looking? Oh, hey, Diamond. Hold on, Leah.
Hey, bruv, we got some violence over here. Oh,
hold on.
One second, we got some violence.
What's going on? That's cheating. What's cheating? Did you not hear the rules, Maurice? I said, are you clear on the rules, bruv? It doesn't matter. It does matter because I'm going to her first. Sorry, Leah. What was you going to say?
Leah, rock the boat.
There we go. Big tune. Did you know that one? You didn't know? You know it. You just went to them just in case. Oh, just to confirm. Yeah. It's because you're a business lady. You do things right. You see it. I see it. Maurice, what's going on, bro? Bro, you were sitting there vibesing. I just saw you. Your eyes went all glazed. And he's like... I saw you. Look, my brother was shouting at you. He's like, bro, you... Bro, he was shouting at you. He was trying to tell you the answer.
It was a bonus, sorry.
Okay. Well, don't do that. Otherwise, you ain't going to win. All right. Diamond, let's go for this next second track. All right, we're going to Leah. Order. Hold on, we got my mic on it.
Order.
Yo, what's going on? Who's my man and why are you doing it?
Ooh, hold on. Before you stand up, bruv, get your shit right. We got beef, we need security.
Maurice, is this your
friend?
Oh
shit, that is security.
Is this your friend? Do you know this guy? See, everybody don't know what you're saying.
Bro, don't take this so serious, bro.
Hold on.
First of all, you have to put your hand up and say Kinetic, and I saw this lady do that.
That's my mum, you know.
All right.
Big up Mumsy.
All right. Mama T said, innit? She said, innit? I have to be, hey, I'm following the rules. Mama T said. Maurice, your team is getting vexed, you know? It's even getting vexed, bro.
What's the score?
You're not winning. All right, Leah.
James, super freak.
There we go.
You know what? My man actually said MC Hammer as well, you know, so he got it wrong.
I tell you what. Diamond. Keep that tune there. Tell you what. I'll give Maurice teams a point if my man can give me the MC Hammer shuffle. There we go. He was talking the big talk. Talking the artist. Talking the artist. There we go. Next tune there. Next. Maurice, what's going on, bro? 2-0 down, you know. The chat are laughing. Mama T is the best.
I got Mama T.
Okay, you believe. All right, let's hit it then. 2-0 to Leah. Diamond, what's the next track?
I don't even can understand how they didn't understand you and that Mary Joy.
Yeah, I
kick
know,
that old
man.
Robotic, futuristic George Jetson. Yeah, crazy well, joy.
Down, just like you in the blab.
Yeah. Maurice, you were slow with it, but I'll give it to you. Bro, that pace was like... All right. Maurice, where is it?
Craig Mack, get down.
Craig Mack, get down.
The artist is correct, but I don't know what you said after that, bruv.
Are we accepting that? Are we accepting that?
That's a half point, you know.
It's a half. It's a half. Sorry, Leah, we're giving the half, innit? My man's getting vexed over there. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. All right. It's 2.5. All right, next track. Can't hear. What? Yeah, Leah.
Cameo a candy.
Word up, cameo.
Yeah. Wait. Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Well done.
It was word up, cameo. There we go. We got 1.5 points. No, you got 1.5, bro. 1.5. And she got 2. There we go. Well done, Maurice's team. Yo, your team are half dead, bro. Leah's team is still alive. You hit? Bro, you got to motivate the squad.
We're coming back.
You look shocked at that phrase as well. We're coming back. You sure?
It's coming home, mate.
All right, here we go. Next track.
Luther Vandross, never too much.
Hey, look, the team's coming alive. 2.5 points to Maurice, 2 points to Leah. Okay, feeling good now. Yeah, you did. Here we go. Hey, I have to say though, like the front row are helping you out, you know, look at this.
Yeah. No, my whole team is.
Okay. Humble with the wins. I like it. Humble with the wins. Okay, Leah. You still in the game? Okay. Early days. Okay. Hey, hold on. What's that? Are you trying to Shazam? Put the phone down. You're recording.
She's addicted, mate.
She's trying to Shazam, you know. You don't have it? Oh, well, you ask Google, yeah? Okay, that's true. Yeah, she don't know shit. Okay. All right, Diamond, we're ready.
I want to be Don Brandy.
Oh, yeah. Classic. 3.5. Yeah.
The comeback king is on his roll.
Yeah. You're feeling good now. Hey, Maurice, who did you come with today?
My mom.
Your mom? Oh, nice. Where's Mumsy? Oh, hey, Mumsy. How's it doing?
Big up, Mumsy.
You proud, Mumsy? You proud? Yes. Nah. The royal wave. I see it, yeah. Mumsy was like, yeah. Okay. All right, here we go. All right, Diamond, we next? Let's do it. Ooh. Yeah. Oh, she gone.
What up?
Donald Jones, what's
know what's up.
Yes, 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 yes.
Ooh, girl, you know what's up. Ooh, and I like it, baby. Girl, you know what's up. Ooh.
Hey, big tune that one. Big tune, big tune. Okay, okay. Three and a half. Still winning. Still winning that half, hey. That half. No, no grabbing. No grabbing. I need to hear him say kinetic, nice and clear, then I'll go to him for the answer.
This is a serious family, you know, bro. They take things serious, isn't it?
You see.
They take everything serious.
You see.
Mommy, why don't you sit on the chair there? Look, look there. There's a chair right there. Why are you sitting on the floor?
You look like you're going to just take her bag and run or something.
That's it, mommy. Come sit down, innit? There we go.
Why didn't you tell your mom to sit down on the chair?
She's not on my team, technically.
Oh, okay.
But she is now.
Family feuds.
You see it, innit? Some people been locked in lockdown for too long, innit? Okay. Okay. All right. Diamond, what's next?
This is how we do it.
Montel Jordan, this is how we do it.
Give it up for Maurice. You know what? Maurice, I won't lie. At the start, I thought you didn't have it in you, bro. But you proved me wrong. I look stupid. Well done. Well done, you. Well done to the team. Well done. You need one more point to win. Leah, what? What happened? The team, look, the team morale is low. Look. Look at my guy and his partner there. They're just like, we don't know Montel Jordan. Well, you have to go into the crowd to ask for that. look at him. He's confident with it. You knew that one, innit? You see, you knew that one. Big up the Von Dutch. All right, Leah.
Yes.
I'm gonna offer you this one time. Do you need a helper for the next one to come up on the stage and help you with this next one?
Yes.
You do. Yes. Von Dutch, she's calling you in. Von Dutch, it's you, bro. Von Dutch is like, nah, bro. Okay, who would you like to nominate, Leah? Daniel. All right, make some noise for Daniel. Okay. Look at this, bubble massive over here. All right. Maurice, you're not even sweating, are you? It's cool with it. I love it. All right, Diamond. Maurice needs 1 point. Leah needs 2.
That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast.
KRS-One, the sound of the police.
Yeah!
That's the sound of the police. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the beast.
Whoop, whoop.
That's the sound of the police.
Whoop, whoop.
That's the sound of the police.
Well done! Maurice has won the game! Give it up for Maurice. Mom, ooh, look at that. Look, my mom's giving you a selection of celebrations. There you go. Straight from Mama T. Round of applause for Leah and Daniel as well. Round of applause. There we go. Well done. Ah, that's nice, that is. Look, he gave it to Mumsy as well. That's nice. Mumsy, you can stay there if you want, you know. What, you right at the back? Oh, you got food? Oh, okay. Hope the Twitch Massive are doing well. Thank you very much for the donations coming in. Keep them coming in. As I said, we are raising money for Crisis UK, help eradicate homelessness. And so if you guys can donate, donate, it'd be fantastic if you can give whatever you can give. 2020 was a madness for everyone. We can all help out. Okay. Now. All right. Hey, Leah, what's going on? Oh, yeah, sorry, mum. Can you come back? Sorry. My mum is like, stop playing with the mic. I just wiped that down. All right. Is everybody ready for the next act this evening? Are we ready at the back? You guys can hear? Thank you. Perfect, perfect. Okay, what I'm going to do is, everybody at the back, start the round of applause, and it's going to ripple forward.
Bruv. We need some bubbling to go on first, you know?
We need some bubbling. Hold on, hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. There's a delay. Hold on. All right, Diamond wants some bubbling. You want to bubble them nice. Oh, hey. Boom, 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 boom. Stop, drop. Shove it down, dump it down, stop. And say, what? Hey, we got the Rough Riders. R.I.P. DMX, man. Right, everybody at the back, start that round of applause. Ripple it forward. There we go. Keep it coming. Get some cheers in there. And welcome to the stage, Jenny Collier.
Ah, thanks so much. What a lovely welcome. Hi, everyone. Hi. Oh, my God. This is so nice. I can't tell you how good it is to do a gig to actual human faces again. It's so good. Lovely to be here. I did a few Zoom gigs over lockdown. My very first one in March last year. The promoter put the password up on Twitter like 5 minutes before the show. And we got inundated by just like dozens of strangers just tossing up. I can't do it, but they're just... They're just tossing off. So this is already enchanting. Because no one's got their dick out. Yet. It blew my mind, like seeing this many people just ready to go. Like I never knew that there were that many people just ready to go at the drop of a hat. Just go. We need to harness this power. If we could harness this power, we wouldn't need fossil fuels. We wouldn't need wind farms. We wouldn't need fracking. Wouldn't that be a nice legacy to come out of lockdown with? Wank farms for the environment. Yes. At the moment, the only legacy we've got from COVID is just everyone's got slightly less of a gag reflex. From the tests. I had my first lockdown up in Wales, where I'm from, but I came back to London because that's where my vibrator is. I'm Welsh. I'm from a little rural North Welsh village, which is called... Well, it's spelt Danielan, but it's pronounced fuck off back to England, yeah. But I don't really sound very Welsh, but that's because my dad's English, so I'm kind of diet Welsh. Welsh light. I can't believe it's not English. I'm diet Welsh, which means I enjoy the rugby, but I've never actually been in a sheep. Where my parents live, right, they live in the middle of bumfuck nowhere, like there's nobody there, right? So I was like, we're not going to be able to hear the clapter for the NHS, right? But then on the first week, I was like, we're not going to hear it. And on the second week, I was like, actually, it sounds like a really lovely thing. I want to get involved. So I went out to the end of the lane, and I can hear, like, some pots and pans. I was like, oh, it's really nice. So I beeped my car horn, and then I can hear the neighbor's dog barking. And I'm like, what a world. I'm beeping my car horn, the neighbor's dog is barking, and that's to say thank you to the doctors. How are they going to get that message? Oh, my God, I love the NHS. I do. I use them a lot. Like, if I've got anything wrong with me, I get it looked at. I'm a heavy user of the NHS. I'll tell you about what I did the year before COVID, just after the Edinburgh Festival, right? I got a suspected concussion. Okay, it was a bit of a party month. Had a suspected concussion. I went to the doctor. They're like, right, we're going to get to the bottom of it. They did, how many fingers am I holding up? They shone a light in my eye. They sent me to hospital. They were so thorough, right? They did a swab in my mouth. They did a swab up my bum. I was like, what do you want with my bum? It's my head. It turns out if you're in hospital, they want to test for MRSA, and that hides up your bum. So they do the mouth, the bum, in that order, and then they sent me in for a head x-ray. They're amazing. It turned out I was just allergic to my new hat, though. So, thanks, NHS. Sauce NHS. But the Zoom gigs that I've done, a lot of them paid less than what my niece gets from the Tooth Fairy. So I ended up getting a job in lockdown, and guess what I was? Oh my God, I was an NHS hero. Oh my God, thank you. Thank you so much. Seven of you clapping, I really appreciate it. You might retract your clapter when I tell you what I was at the NHS. I was a GP receptionist. Oh. Yeah, no one's clapping now. We are famously cunts. We have got a reputation for being really rude bitches, and it's because it's a really hard job. Okay, so you've got like 13,000 patients, unlucky for some. You've got 10 doctors, and the doctors are doing a great job, but they don't want to see anyone. And so you're just keeping the two apart, right? It's a hard job. My very first day, my first job, like they let me in easy. I was booking in flu jabs for the very old, old patients. So it was last September, normal flu jabs, I'm calling them up. Got a spreadsheet where I've got their name, NHS number, I copy their NHS number into the system, brings up their profile, I call them, I book it in. The second person on the list, I copy the number across into the system, it comes up red, deceased. And I was like, if I'd started this day a job sooner, could I have saved their life? I don't know if I can do this job. This is maybe a bit too emotional for me. Like, I've only been here 5 minutes and I'm already faced with mortality. This is too much. I don't know if I can handle this. By the end of my first day, towards the bottom of the spreadsheet, if I'm copying the number into the system and it comes up red deceased, I'm going, yes, I don't have to call them. So it's surprising how quickly you can adapt to the situation. A plus side as well of working in the surgery is I got, we had a blood pressure monitor in there, which I used to use most days, just because it felt like a little hug. Not much pity now after I've shown myself to be a bit of a bitch. Yeah, so I was in Wales for the lockdown, thought I'd learn a bit of the Welsh language. You want to learn some words? Pandemeg. Pfizer-BioNTech. Microwave in Welsh. Poppity-ping. Poppity-ping. And loads of people think that's because a microwave goes poppity-ping, but it isn't. It actually translates literally as ping bakery. Ha-ha. Oh, adorbs. Anybody know what jellyfish is in Welsh? Sounds a bit rude, okay, brace yourselves. Sglefrod môr translates literally as cunt of the ocean. It's a beautiful language. Good old Wales. But the STI clinic where I grew up, that's now turned into a bar. Not because I left. They just decided to turn it into a bar. It's called a clinic bar. That means a clinic bar. They sell STI-themed cocktails. Can't write that shit. So they've got Hepspresso martinis. Penile coladas. Bloody Mary's just the same. Oh, a bit dirty. Is that cutting out? Can you hear me? Am I in a coma? Oh my God, it's time to go. It's time for me to go home. No. What else? I've referred to my vibrator. Have I told you I'm single? Don't know if that's come across yet. I talk a lot about being kind of lonely and single on stage, and quite often men will come up to me at the end of gigs, usually quite unattractive men. And they'll be like, oh, so you're looking for a man? Well, go on then, I'll have your number. So I just want to say right here and now, just to save anybody the time or humiliation, it's 07789-684-068. Not one person's writing, okay, that's rude. I mean, I love being a comedian, but it can be quite a lonely job sometimes. I'll tell you about a thing that happened to me a while ago. I was doing a gig up in Durham, right, and I'd driven all the way from London that day, so I was knackered. So I thought, I'll have a little lie down in my hotel room before the show. So I go into my hotel room by myself, have a little lie down, and then I can hear straight away the couple in the room next door to me are boning, right? And they're really flipping, going for it. Right, they're not being vocal, they're just at it. And I was like, God, shut up! four. God, I wish they'd shut up. Four. Do you know what I'm saying? Got a bit swept up in it. Okay, so we all finished about the same time. So I was like, oh my God, we'd make a great threesome. But then later to go to my gig, I had to go past their room to leave the hotel. And as I go past their room, I look up at what I thought was their door. It was just the laundry. It was just the washing machine hitting the wall. I wish that wasn't true. To be fair, it sounded like a full load though, so I'm having it. Oh. I've got a few theories about why I'm single. So first of all, I think I share a bit too much. No. No, I do. Like on a first date, I might go to the loo, and then when I come back, I'll say, oh, sorry, I took so long. There was a queue in my bowel. Another reason for my singledom might be the fact the only bras that truly fit me have got Disney characters on them. So if I were a grown-up's bra or lingerie, I look like I'm wearing some kind of elaborate waistcoat. I've just had a light. I was going to talk you through my bra size, but I haven't got time. You've been so lovely. Thanks for having me. I'm Jenny Collier. Bye.
Give it up for Jenny. We got Jenny Collier right there. Oh, ooh, I keep getting tangled. You guys having a nice time? Cool, awesome. Just a quick reminder. Also, if you want to grab your drinks, make sure you use the QR code. And also for the guys that are on Twitch, we almost hit our donation goal, which is fantastic for Crisis UK. So thank you very much. Keep those donations coming in. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you. What's going on? What's happened there? Huh? I thought you was taking, is that a shawl? Oh, it's wet. How did it get wet? Okay. People at the back are here. It just sounds like it's just us two talking. What's your name? Hello. What's your name? Alicia. Everybody say hello to Alicia. Alicia, you here with your best friend today? That's nice. That's nice. I'm going to need your help, Alicia. Yeah. We're going to bring on our next act. All right? Now, a lot of people at the back keep telling me they can't hear too tick, they can't hear too tough. So I'm gonna need you to vocalize, say, oh, hey, yo, listen up. I'm gonna bring on the next act. Is that cool? Yeah, because they can't hear me at the back right now. You see what I'm saying? Like Stefan can. Big up Stefan. There you go. Big up the Welsh Massive in the room. Just him. We got any other Welsh people in? Yeah, it's just Steph. It's just Steph. Just you, bro. Yeah. I'm sure we got some Welsh people watching online. Yeah, but she's gone now. She's literally left the building. All right. Well, Stefan, maybe you can help me out with Alicia, right? Alicia, you're going to say, hey, Stefan, hear this. Nice, nice, nice. We got Aurie Styla coming on, and he's sick. Translating it for the Welsh Massive, I see it. That's nice, that's nice. So, Stefan, tell your people at the back to make some noise, and then everyone's going wild. It's time for Aurie Styla! Yo, what's going on, everybody? Is everyone all right? If you are, say oi oi! Lovely. How do you translate my name to all, like, talent? What happened there? Literally, he said, we got Aurie Styla. He went, yo, we got some pussy old coming on this thing. I'm like, raw! That's what it felt like, innit? Have I upset you in, like, a previous life or something? Have I done you wrong? No. No worries. That's cool. That's fine. All right. Thank you, Alicia. I'm hurt by that, you know. A little bit.
Nah, it's all right. My name's not the easiest of names, so that's okay. I don't even care. Listen, I'm just happy to be out and about. How many of you can just honestly say, it don't matter how much people are here, where you are, you're just happy to be out of your yard and be able to enjoy it? Get me? Yo! Except for those on Twitch. I meant the people that are here. You lot Twitch, you lot carry on what you're doing. Nice. I tell you what, I tell you this, from now on, I just don't want to hear and see no more press conferences. I'm not the only one, I think. Not one more press conference. I know the information they was trying to tell us was for our own good, but nonetheless, I don't want to hear no more. Do you know what it is? It's not so much the info that I'm annoyed with. I need to feel confident that you know what you're saying, and the way that you say it is going to let me know how confident you are. Because the information we've been getting from that podium, from the voice we've been getting it from, instills no confidence in me at all. Good afternoon, ladies. Nah, start again. Bass and don't make it quiver. Hello, everybody, ladies and gentlemen, we are inside. No, we're dead. Can you sort this out? Can we get someone who's a bit more confident to relay the information, please? I'm not on it. The man looked me dead in my eye at Christmas and said to me, "Tis the season to be jolly, but... Tis the season to be jolly, careful." No, we're dead. Dead. I'm not even going to blame him too tough. I'm not saying I like or dislike him. The only thing I will say is, for anybody that has an opinion, be honest, when my man handed in his CV, he did not think he'd have to deal with the zombie apocalypse to write it. So give him a little bit of leeway just on that. That's all I'm going to say. You know what upset me even more? Rishi Sunak. Man looked me dead in my eye and said, "Retrain, brother. Retrain. I'm a comedian because I couldn't train the first time round." Mate, I'm telling you, I can't see no more press conferences. The confidence just ain't there for me, man. I found a way to like get all the information I needed and feel a bit more, you know, confident in myself about what's been given to me. And the way that you do it, you lot can try this if we get another one, right? When the conferences are on, mute the television, put the subtitles on, read it in your own voice. It will give you the, read it in your dad's voice. I would see it and say, "Yo, everybody, ladies and gentlemen." I'm like, "Yes. We are gonna be nice soon, see?" And I'm like, "Yes, father. I believe you." But the thing is, you still gotta look in his face. And he gives you little hints as to why what he's saying, he's a bit nervous of. I'm not saying that he might be wrong or right in what he's saying. I'm just saying he don't necessarily believe it. He's a bit scared. Because he would look at you, then he would look down. And how many of us saw his cranium every time the conferences were going off and thinking, "We're dead. We're dead." Because his hair would look at him and say, "Excuse me, my hair is socially distancing. You have to give me a break." I'm like, "Big man, we are dead. Send me to Mars. Let's just start again." Man, the pandemic was a lot for a lot of people. But the people I give respect to the most, kind of, parents, right? You lot had a big, do you remember, anyone who's not got a kid right now, do you remember when your friends used to look at you, the ones that had kids, and said, "Oh my God, you should get some, they're a blessing." This is before a pandemic. Think about, you remember when they used to tell you that? I'm a dickhead if I followed you. Because in the pandemic, firstly, they yam out your fridge. I've never seen so many parents in Costco every week just for a reload in my life. And then afterwards, when you got told you had to stay home and work, furlough whatsoever, kids were being homeschooled, and I think a lot of parents, adults in general, started to realize the difference between the education they got and the education the kids got. I'm not saying the kids are necessarily smarter, but they process information a lot more differently and a lot more quicker than we do. I went to my sister's house. She got a son, my nephew, 10 years old. Cool guy, like him, love him, he's my nephew. He plays Xbox a lot. Doesn't really get into anyone's mix-up or business, right? And my sister's getting agitated because he's interrupting her, correcting her on her grammar every time he's playing the Xbox because he's better educated. The phone would ring. "Hello, who am I speaking to?" "Mum, it's to whom are you speaking with?" "Shut up and play Fortnite. I'm not conversating with you." "Conversing, Mum. This ain't my family." He's like that. I took him to my house for a little bit just to give her a break, innit? Just to say I can deal with him, because as soon as I deal with him for a couple of days, I could send him back. And that's fine. She can have him back after that. Came to my house, annoyed me, because I'm sitting there. This was about May, June, something like that. I'm there doing my tax return. I'm sweating. I like to think I'm sweating because I'm making big money and the tax bill's big. That ain't the case. I have to pay last year's tax bill with no gigs this time round. I was scared. This little pussy, see me at the computer, see me at the computer sweating beads. He walks up and he does that lean in to look at the screen. And he goes, yo, Unc, why are you sweating? What are you doing? I said, this is tax return. This is big people stuff. He leans in again and goes, I don't know why you're sweating. That looks easy to me, bruv. And he stretched out the easy to me, you know. And he started to walk. I said, come here. You don't even know what tax pays for, right? I don't want to hear nothing from you. He looked in the screen again and went, I may not know what it pays for, but that's maths. You must be dunce, because I can figure that out myself. I said, he wants to die. He must do. Like, I'm thinking the way to save money is to get rid of someone who's hemorrhaging money. I'm doing my sister a favor if I kill you right now. That's what I'm thinking. But I went down another route. I said, you know what? If the tax return is easy, you do it. And he said, all right, Dan, I will. And he sat down. And I took a step back. And he said to me, as long as you do my maths homework. I said, what? I thought you were trying to embarrass me. But he's 10. His maths homework can't be that hard. I'm a big man. You can't put maths homework in front of me. What, 2 + 2 = 4? I could do that. Send the book, come. He brings the book to me. Page 14 with a bookmark on it, yeah? And he's underlined the question he's got to work on next. I bust open the book. I looked at it. I kid you not, these were the words that I read, and it gave me fear. It started like this. Without the use of a calculator. I'm done already. What can I say? But I carried on. Diamond, I carried on. I did. And I looked at it, yeah? It said, without the use of a calculator, state the volume of this sphere by using pi to 7 decimal places. Pi has 7 decimal places. When I was younger, pi was 3.14 and dead. Nothing else. Nothing else. Now they have to calculate it as 22 divided by 7, and that is infinite numbers. First things first, how many of you needed to use pi past 16? No one. You didn't need to use pi, a Bunsen burner, a set square, a protractor. Why are you teaching me this? None of you went to the burger shop and said, hey, big man, listen, the volume of that BAP is not what I paid for. None of you have done that. But I learned two things that day. Two things. One, teachers, if you're a teacher here, just give me a wave real quick. I big up you, because you had to keep their education on a high level whilst they're on Zoom, ignoring you watching Netflix and still being able to educate them. That can't be easy. I learned that teachers, you lot are the real soldiers, honestly. And lesson number two, I saved £747 on my tax. That pussy's my tax accountant now. Every time. He's my accountant from now on. I'm saving money. I'm sorry. I sometimes refer to family members like that. It happens. Let's be honest. We all got family members in here that we don't like. Let's be real. Come on. And if none of you agree with me, if you're not agree with me, you're that family member. Let's be honest. That's you. Mine's my nephew. Made me want to leave. I left London. I left. That lockdown made me not want to stay in London no more, right? Only because I love London. I grew up raised here. But you know when you get told to stay home, you realize how much space you don't have in the house that you have? My God, I'm living in Harry Potter's bedroom. The first one he had before he moved to Hogwarts, it was cramped. So I decided to move out of London, right? And what I did is I moved to a little village called Great Denham. I know you're looking at me thinking, Ross, you, village. Yes, village, big man. And this is what I did. I house hunted. I'm going to give you a little advice on how to house hunt, right? If you are looking to do it now, there's something you need to do. It's important, right? When you are searching for a house, Google it, but don't stay on the all tab. Don't even go on images. The news tab is the way you need to be looking. That will tell you everything you need to know about the area that you're looking to move into. Google Halsden, Peckham, original Peckham, not gentrified Peckham, original Peckham. Google Moss Side in Manchester. It will let you know burglary is on the rise, carjackings. And it's not just hot, it's not just hood areas. Nice areas have their crimes too. Google Chelsea, bank fraud on the rise. It's all happening. I Googled Great Denham, nothing came up. I thought this place looked nice. It had swans and river. I was like, yes, this is where I need to go. I'd be the only one, but I'ma be there. And I started looking, thinking, yeah, this looks good. Put down a deposit, right? waiting for them to accept. They accepted. I'm like, yes, but let me just Google the area again. Nothing came up, just right move, Stripe, Zoopla. Just trying to advertise people to come. I said, yeah. I Googled it again after it went to exchange. Nothing came up. I said, this is wicked. No badness. Just adverts for people to come in because it's a new village. It went to completion, which means I'm locked in. I have to move. And I Googled it one more time. And the first thing that came up under the news tab, a Sun article. I said, shit, what's happening now? I looked, I thought, nah, I'm done for. I'm done for. I'm scared. Because I can't back out now. I clicked on the article. The headline said, young black comedian from London moving to Great Denham. I said, no, this place is going downhill. No, no. Listen, if you guys got social media, please follow me at Aurie, A-U-R-I-E, Styla, S-T-Y-L-A. Big up Kinetic Comedy and my brother I know as well, man. Thank you, guys. God bless and take care. Later.
Give it up for Aurie Styla.
Hey, that was fantastic, man. Did you guys enjoy that? Right, we're going to have one more interval, then we're going to be back with some more competitions and one more fantastic comedian. Give it up for all the acts you've seen so far. I'll see you guys in a little piece. Diamond, let's hear some tunes. We'll be right back.
room. I gotta know who you fucked in this room. I gotta know who you fucked in this room. Can't trust no bitch. Can't trust these niggas. In love with my money. In love with my pistol. In love with my beats. I think she my bitch. I know she's her bitch.
Are you having a good time? So incredible.
Check me out. Jersey, baby, where I eat. Fresh out the gym. 350s on the feet. Rubicon Jeep kitted out. I keep relevant. Tommy Hill can't figure.
Check.
Club is wildin'. I just stepped in.
Shout out to the chat, massive.
I felt my Evans. I pushed up in her.
I think we got about 5 minutes.
Not Department of Correction. I don't give a fuck. Your boy, relax. I gotta watch it.
Apologies for the swearing.
Bruh, I'm moving. I get that bag. You're running in place, getting hip hop abs. Middleweight champ. Death Squad camp. Slick with the words. You write like Vance. The man chicks want to sign their implants. Raise my gun like I got strict parents.
Let's go.
So hood, what about you? Money on the books, got no IQ. 90s at NYU, bitches, hooshnickins practicing gun foo. I was out there when Big got shot, and ever since then, I move like SWAT. And OG like B-Hop, still in the ring. I'm angry, I'm EDI mean. About that green, like what?
Are you having a good time? Are you having a good time?
For the second time, they smashing glass on the floor. What's going on?
Having a good time.
They're a bit rowdy over there, you know.
Let's go, nigga.
Security.
VVS is on the wrist, so I can raise my fist up like Kaepernick. In the place, no hectic. Nope, dog mama, say red, yeah, he that shit. What y'all want, huh? We want the bud. Photoshop how I get uglier. Back in the game with no plug.
Oh, we got the fire rabbit, you know.
Fucking with a sub. I don't give a fuck, I'm MPV. Flint even know how this MC breed. Look, bruh, I'm moving.
We shout out to Chicken Nugs.
Top 10 bats with the shopper rank around the bar.
Old tight Luna Sweets.
Till I get out my car and let it park. I stunt, nigga.
We shout out to everybody watching on the Twitch stream.
Mo, bit.
Much appreciated.
Stop, let's go. Homie, you are no frill. I'm a big deal like when Raina got killed.
Don't forget we're supporting Crisis today.
For real, behind the wheel.
Make a donation if you can, please.
Young and I ain't with that. I'm about money, still get a wick check. Retarded flow, my dad had insects. I see niggas, I don't make a diss track at all.
Are you having a good time? Ladies and gentlemen, are you having a good time? Are you having a good time? Are you having a good time? Let's go, nigga. Are you having a good time?
Right, is everyone settled?
Are you having a good time? 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 So incredible. Are you having a good time? Are you having a good time? Are you having a good time?
Remington Salam, let them ring the alarm. Push crime, push crime. Elijah, I'm on so wicked man, I push gun principle. See them now, put on them AK-49 rifle. Stop move up the main triangle. Watch out. Now them push crime, push crime. Gone up the river, gonna go spend big time. Gone up the river, gonna go push big time. Gone up the river, gonna go pay for crime. Gone up the river, gonna go push big time. I don't know where to take them ungrateful mankind. The fella them slaughter some great friend of mine. Forward, I miss a cock up, I rewind. No dollar, no quarter, no nickel, no dime. Pretty yellow moon, make some great gold coin. I thought the virgin of the sweet as she wine. Now she cock up on the reggae, take a sweet grape wine. Grape wine, grape wine, she drip wine. It's more side Joseph, it take you one AI. 19,000 catty a coil, take it one first time, first time, first time. It's more side one of you is IATM1. Gold Rolex, high times, high times, high times, high times. Gone up the river, gonna go spend big time. Gone up the river, gonna go push big time. Gone up the river, gonna go pay for crime. Gone up the river, gonna go push big time. Counsel against I'm most I savoy is law is a sinful crime. Well, watch out. On top of living at the ghetto as a poor is a crime. Prison fighting with their logic.
Big shout out to Aurie Styla.
The government crime. On top of government fighting their people, it's a shameful, dangerous crime. Well, watch out. It's a wild apart.
Really moved out into the sticks, you know, bruv.
Wild. What are you doing? Did fight a war with the Calvary General One and Sherman and General Moyle. Well, watch out. I man will fight them no more. Forever soaring Chief Joseph Troy. Sign up the river, gonna go spend big time.
Also, big up Russell Hicks.
River gonna go push big time.
Big shout out to Johnny Cochrane.
River gonna go pay for crime.
Nice one, Jelly, Collier.
Big time. Them ungrateful mankind. The fella them slaughter some.
We got a little competition coming up. Then we got the last act coming up.
No quarter, no nickel, no.
Aww.
Pretty yellow moon make some great gold coin. I thought the virgin of the sweet as she wine. Now she cock up on the reggae, take a sweet grape wine. Grape wine, grape wine, she drip wine.
Yeah. So I. Yes.
It's about that time, you know.
I and I.
Shout to the Twitch crew.
Second another puff, see me with me spliff, yeah. Why it disturb you when me burn my ganja plant? And you know, say it, fill me with the scripture. It legal round the world, but them still a fight the herbs. See me with me spliff, yeah. White earth, yeah, when me burn my ganja.
Big shout to J-Dubes. Love that hat, bruv.
The scripture. Enough man they a jail for a little spliff deal when I crave. Yeah.
Reloading this one for J-Dubes.
Yes, I
like that skank there, bruv.
I and I. Second another buff, see me with me spliff, yeah. Why it disturb you when me burn my ganja plant? And you know, say it, fill me with the scripture. It legal round the world, but them still a fight the earth. See me with me spliff, yeah. White earth, yeah, when my burn my ganja plant. And you know, say it, fill me with the scripture. Enough man, they a jail for a little spliff deal. When a crazy money making for those on a rich scale. As defenses taking orders on a legal quick sale. Jamaica every day should have a ganja ship sale. Filling orders from my brothers, them a reaching Gmail. We could fail. Economies on the rise in places that it legalized. The only thing is that the regular man can capitalize. Card the lights of fee pay him off to buy special supplies. 250 to you know, no really drop from outer skies. Well, five away. We have said we're ready to start a franchise. We say we're gonna call it Natural Eyes. Many hustlers in a lockup and some farmer sacrifice. Still we're gonna
check, check, with check, the check, check. Price, the herb, mic burn, check. Burn, we are back. Welcome back to the final part of Kinetic Comedy.
Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back. Welcome back. You having a nice time so far, everyone? Awesome, awesome. Raj, how's your first date going? Big, big, big. Kate, is he doing all the right things? He is. Hey, big up Raj, playing it right. Game of chess. Narcy, how you doing back there, bro? All blessed. Nice. Rachel, how you doing? She's good still. She's good still. What about you, Van Dutch? He's good. Big up Van Dutch. Where's Maurice? Where's Maurice? He's at the back. Where's Mumsy gone? Oh, there she is, there she is, there she is. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back, everybody. Now, before we bring on our final comedian onto the stage, got one more competition for you guys. This one is gonna test your knowledge to see who's been paying attention today, yeah? And who's just been just like chilling and not letting everything go past them, yeah? This game is called Do They Really Know Tho? That's right. What was that, J-Diz? What was it called? Do They Really Know Tho? That's right. What was that game called? You don't know. What was the game called? Do They Really Know Tho? What was it called? Do They Really Know Tho? At the back, what was it called?
That's right. Okay. Do they really know, though? The way we play this game is you guys are going to be battling the people online. At the minute, we've got about 500 people watching the live stream of the show. That's right. So you guys are going to be competing with them to see who has been paying attention the most throughout this whole comedy night. All right? Marcus over here is going to put up a series of questions once I tell him, right? And it's up to you guys and you guys on Twitch to type in your answers as quick as possible. The first answer that comes in on Twitch, if it beats you guys, wins. Okay? We're going to see the message over here. In order to compete online, you need to put answer and then type your answer after you've written answer. Okay? Now, for you guys, do you really know, though? Who's been paying attention today? Let me see. Pixie, she's nominated herself for the first one. Okay. First question. Here we go. Marcus. Question one. What was the name of the village that Aurie moved to? Pixie, what was it called? Help her out, she don't know. Help her out, she don't know. Great Denham. Great Denham. It's Great Denham. Well done, well done. Well done. Beat it online. Oh! Chicken and nugs coming just after. Just after on the delay. Lucky on the delay. Now, get ready for question two. Well done, chicken nugs. You were close, but not close enough. Question two. What was that guy's porn star name? Anybody, anybody. What was that? Ginger. Ginger. Oh, was that the full name, Ginger? Was it the full name? Oh, what was that? You have to shout, I can't hear ya. What was it? I can't hear ya. Oh, last DJ goes for Dick Ginger. It was something to do with being Ginger. I'm gonna have to give it to Combini Longuini. Something Ginger. All right. It's one point to you guys. 1 point to the online team. All right, hold up, Marcus. Let's let them catch up. Make sure you refresh your stream if you've got a little bit of delay so you can see the questions as quick as possible online. Okay, remember, online team, put answer, then your answer afterwards. You guys, you're gonna be faster than online people, you know? There's a lot of them. They've been paying attention, as you can see. Marcus, question three. Where did Russell say the nicest races were from? I love it. All the black people went, Kent! Do you know what? I give both teams that point. Both teams get that point. Okay. 2-1 to you guys. There we go.
We got the Sega Zoom.
Oh, no. Two. Say it again. Oh, Sega Zoom. Yes, Sega Zoom. Well done. Okay. Next question. Question four. What was the last song of the Guess the Tune competition? What was the last song? What was that? Say it again loud. KRS One Sound the Police. Marcus. Yes. Well done. Well done. Cameo, word out. No, Johnny. No, it wasn't. It wasn't where that cameo. Here we go. 3 points for you guys. Well done. Well done. Do you really know, though? Okay. All right, Marcus, next question. Question five. Where did the Welsh name for jellyfish translate to? What did it translate? What was that? Say that loud, Kate. Say it loud. Oh, wow. I hope it's that. I hope it's that. Canada Sea. Yes, DW. Yes, it was. May I remind you guys at this point, disclaimer. This stream is intended for adult audiences. Okay. All right. Question six. Let's see. What we got? How old is Aurie's nephew? Oh, Marcus, you got an answer there. Oh! Fuck, Mark has fucked out the question.
You had one job, mate. One job.
He fucked out the question. All right. Scratch that one. Okay. Final question. Final question now. All right. Let's make this one the decider. Marcus, you got it all set? Okay, okay. Final question. Question 7. Here we go. How much money was raised at Crisis UK at the start of the show? What was that? £100 we got over here. £100! Well done. Well done, you guys. Well done, you guys. Well played. And big up Chicken Nugs. Yeah. Well done, you guys. Look at the chicken nugs. That's a wicked name, isn't it? That's a wicked name. Well done, you guys. Let's keep raising money. As I said, we are raising money for Crisis UK. They work super, super hard, especially last year during the pandemic. A lot of the stuff that they wanted to do in terms of helping homeless people, especially at Christmas time, especially when a lot of people have lost their job and subsequently like rent has been mashed up and all them things there. Yeah, all those services weren't available to them, obviously, because of COVID-19 and the pandemic going on. So all the money that you guys are going on to is to help and aid with that charity. As I said, they're there to try and eradicate homelessness. If you guys want to donate, feel free to go online on the Kinetic website and you can donate there and you can see the links for Crisis. If you're watching on a live stream, !donate or !crisis in the chat and the link will pop up and you can donate there. I've seen a whole bunch of people been donating so far, so thank you very much for that. Okay. Right. Are we ready for our final act this evening? Okay. I call this guy the comedy godfather because he's taught me everything I know. I remember meeting him years ago and he's given me all sorts of lessons and made me one of the comedians I am today. So I know you guys are going to love him. So, for the final time this evening, I want you guys to give a very warm, kinetic welcome. All right. Darcy, can you start the round of applause, please? Because we got the legend that is Slim coming to the stage. Please welcome Slim.
Yellow man, minute. I used to have to be done minute. Me set it.
Thank you. How's everybody doing? Can you hear me at the back? You see, that's what you needed, a Jamaican on the mic for morning. We couldn't really hear that good at the back, but I know you lot at the front was enjoying the show because we could hear your laughters, but couldn't hear fuck all. So that's how it goes. Well done for buying your tickets early. Do you see what I mean? Well done. Right. Now, we're back. We're back. I can't believe it. Lockdown. And I feel sorry for all those living with people. Who lives with someone? Make some noise. Who enjoyed the whole lockdown with that same somebody? Make some noise. You fucking liars. You didn't. I enjoyed. You know what? I only now appreciate living by myself. I appreciate that shit. No kids, no fucking naggy woman, none of that shit. And do you know what? I'm actually celebrating being single. I am. Most people don't like celebrating that. I'm celebrating it. People, you don't understand. I started a proper life years ago. I'm 49 now. I started having my first kids at 17. That sounds really young, innit? It does. But you have them when the sperm is strong. Jump in the pom-pom backways and swim. Freestyle up the pom-pom. Before brandy and weed fucks it up. But I'm at a nice age. My kids are grown. I feel like 17 again. All my kids are grown. I'm no longer legally responsible for any of my children. Oi, oi! Fucking habit. I do. I love it. And some of you ain't had kids yet. That's your fucking problem. I started young and they're gone. And I'm so glad.
Because people, I want to say, I'm a proud father and I enjoyed growing them. But those, have we got any parents in today? Parents, make some noise. As you know, there's lots of beautiful things about growing them and there's a lot of shit. There's a lot of stuff you don't like. I didn't like shit like... Brother. Yes, sir. Go on, sir. Go on, sir. I am. Do you have a mortgage? Do you want it to end? No, no, because I'm asking you. Do you want a lifelong mortgage? No, no, make him come up. Make him come up, man, please. Please. Is he with you? Is he with you? Is this your man? Look, she even denied you, you know, brother. The girl you came with said, I don't know this blood clot. Okay, you do realize this is not a political stage. Because black people tend to take comedy as a political thing. And I disagree. I think I'm not a fucking MP. If I was Boris, then you can come up. Objection. Objection. My man walk up here like this is the Commons. But what we're going to do... I'm not a nasty comic. I would like to hear what you got to say. What is it that you think? Hold on. First of all, are you a father? Do you have children? How many? One. Go and fucking sit down. Oh, go sit down, bomber clown. Hold on. How old is your child? How old is your child, sir? No, I can't guess because they could be any age. No, no. How old is your child? Listen, you got to give him more attention. You got to give him more attention. This is not acceptable. Go on then. You've got one child. I got four. What is your child's age? All right. Are they in primary school? What did you order for him? What did you order for him? Yeah. Yes. Prosecco. Big man, you're high on Prosecco. Please. Please. There is white rum drinkers in this bitch. Please. One kid, don't boo him. Don't boo him, because he's got to learn. Don't boo him. I don't like being nasty. All it was going to school him, because I've got four fucking kids. As I said, I had my first child at 17, yeah? I'm 49 now, yeah? I'm a granddad. This bread has just bust nut. Just bust nut. And right now, when you got one, you can't even be sure if that's yours. You gotta have a couple of them to look like each other and say, yeah, no Jeremy Kyle for me. I'm just saying, somebody with one kid can't come up and tell somebody with four children, and that's what's wrong with society right now. Yeah. I'm old school, I told you I'm 49, I'm not one of these young youths, you know. That's why I keep the grey ears. Officer, there's no need for the truncheon. We can reason. I'm celebrating. I don't care what you got to say. Of course it is. Do I sound like I'm aggravated with you? No, of course not. Because I'm going to educate you. Do you go? Do you go to the Christmas school plays? God, I'm going to tell you what I didn't like, as I was saying before. Have you been to one yet? No, man. Listen to me. You know his kid's about 2 months old, innit? And my man just needed all of us to know, my boss not, my man. I object. You're going to go to a Christmas school play, sir, and it's going to be shit. Remember, I fucking told you, load of shit. Listen carefully.
They're going to bring you out into the assembly hall and sit you down on the miniature chairs, sir. Miniature chairs. Or the apparatus bench. Remember the apparatus? See, all parents know it. They sit you down on that shit as a big man. When you try to get up, your back breaks. Rigor mortis. Nobody up on stage knows who's who. They can never remember who's who. You been primary school play before? One year I went and watched Mary standing up for about 2 minutes deciding which one of these motherfuckers Joseph. Don't you practice that shit. And then everybody's heard them singing. Fucking horrendous. It is a load of shit. And you notice they always manage to see you in the audience, innit? Standing up, smiling, waving at you. Like you fucking know them. You're your mother's child today. You are. Woman, you love everything. You lot don't get embarrassed by it. Fuck all. You don't. I didn't like them cooking at school and bringing that poison home for me to fucking eat. See, dads laugh. Mums don't like that. My baby, my baby. I had to tell my baby mother, don't eat from him. He's looking to kill us. Looking hurly inheritance. But here, I cook something for you. Have you ever done that? Where they jump in front of you and then you have to think on your feet. I've just eaten, baby. I tell you what, I'll take it and eat it later. Which means I'm going to throw it in the fucking bin. You know how it is, parents. I will say it, I will eat from the girls, not the boys. I've got 2 boys, 2 girls. I'll eat from my daughters. Why? Girls, we don't want to say, but in general, I am telling you, you are much more hygienic than boys, yeah? Boys, never eat from them. Never. You've all seen teenagers, whether you've got a kid or not. You've watched teenagers, observe them, just lounging around, doing fuck all. When a teenage boy is lounging around doing fuck all, most of the time, where's his hands? Where is his hands? Down his trousers, innit? Scratching his balls up. Scratching his batty. I don't want no batty biscuits. Fucking crutch cookies. Who wants that? Give that to your mother. She loves everything. Not you. You're not eating from the boys neither. I salute you. And I don't want to sound hard on the kids. As I said, I enjoyed growing them. But like when you come to the end of it, you reevaluate all the years you've gone through. And I realize we need to lower the age of consent. The age of legal responsibility. Legal responsibility for these kids. 18 years is too fucking long. I'm telling you, ask any parent. They need to take 4 years off that bitch. Lower it to 14. Because everybody knows 14-year-olds are fucking know-it-alls. Well, know yourself to the job centre, my son. Yes, yes. They think they know it all. But out, we're the only mammals on earth, you know. My man keeps shaking his head. I'm going to give you a fact, Mr. Rasta man. Yeah? We're the only mammals on earth that keep their kids for 18 years. Watch Animal Planet. You'll be jealous. You'll be jealous. You will. Look, you lot watch Animal Planet. Have you ever seen a lion with a teenage lion walking behind him moaning, I don't want to go hunting? You don't see that shit. You don't. They don't keep them that long. As soon as they can see good, stand good later. On your fucking bike, son. That's what we need to do with the kids.
My man, the lion, the man, the
No, 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 no. Let's hear it. Let's hear it. Hold on. Let me ask you something. I am Africa. Do you own a lion? Do you own a lion? Oh, no, 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 no. No, no, no. Stop, 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 stop. No, no, stop, 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 stop. Stop. Big man, you're drinking too much. And you're, hold on, hold on. And you're embarrassing the lady next to you. She is fine, and that's how you're going to go out. You ain't a lion. You can't drink. Lions don't drink beer, pussy hole. I'm the wrong brother, you know. Believe me, you see the grey hairs? I'm the wrong brother. I'm the wrong brother. I'm the wrong brother. I'm the sit down, have your date. Hold on, leave him, leave him, leave him, leave him. Because she ain't gonna, hold on. Hold on, she ain't, hold on. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Let him talk, let him talk. Let him talk, let him talk, let him talk, let him talk. I will ask you, hold on. Are you gonna, hold on, hold on. Are you fucking him tonight? You're not. You're not. This is what I'm saying. Yeah, listen, listen. Hold on. Big man, you do realize this is not a political party. This is not ANC. Do you understand? No, 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 no. You're disturbing the show. Cheer him if he's making you laugh. Give him a round of applause if he's making you laugh, people. No, it ain't playing, bro. You're disturbing the show. You're drunk. You're starting to slur. You're closing your eyes. All that. Please, keep him in thing. Because he's embarrassing you as well. Yeah? I'm not a fucking politician. Remember that. So you sitting down waiting to respond to what I've got to say tells me you're unhappy in life.
Yeah.
I am telling you that.
Real talk.
Whatever. Whatever is bothering you, deal with it. Don't come to a comedy show, drink, and then, like I'm a politician, or Hancock, go blood clot parliament and do that with a white man.
Yes, exactly.
Don't come here and do that with me. And please, remember my face. I'm not no young youth with all that try fancy shit. You are fucking up the show.
Yes, come on.
You hear me?
Come on.
I don't know your age. But I know you're younger than me, so show me Pussy Clark respect. Yeah? Now, this, you know what? This is the right work for me. This is the right work. Because if I was like a cashier, can you imagine him giving no thing? And this is the thing. When you're in a normal work, people can say shit. But at my work, I can say, yo, pussy on, fuck yourself. Fuck yourself. And I won't get sacked. They'll still pay me. Stop picking on comics. You lot got it twisted. Too much people come to comedy shows now, upset about life. And the minute comics say something, you lot jump up on them. I've not insulted no one. Is it? But him don't know that. Him drink. Him can't spell entertainment right now. Don't do that, man. I'm kind of ashamed of you. With the locks, dark-skinned brother and that, I thought you'd have backed me. But you come up here, and you're the one that's trying to disrespect me. No, don't tell me to cut that out. You should control this pussy hole. Yeah? Good. Don't blood clot ever come and think that I'm one of them brother there. Good. People, that's my time. Love and peace.
Slim!
Wow!
Wow!
Wow! Wow! Wow! Wow! Wow! Wow! Wow! Wow! Wow! That's a lot. That's a lot to unpack.
It was a lot, you know.
That's a lot to unpack.
So much happened there. So much happened there.
Issues. Issues. Therapy. Therapy.
Yeah. That's a lot, you know. That's a lot.
Matting.
And you know, at the height of all of that, we had like 1,000 viewers as well. It's mad.
1,000 views on
it's
Twitch.
Mad.
Man's gonna be, man's gonna be famous.
It's mad. That could never be me, you know.
Watch your Twitter tomorrow, bruv. Your YouTube.
Watch the Twitter tomorrow.
YouTube tomorrow is gonna be mad.
It's gonna be mad.
Yeah.
It was a lot.
That was a lot.
That was a lot.
We got the Phantom Marigold.
We got the Marigold. Wow. It was a lot. But did you guys have a nice time?
Limb by limb. We have cut them down.
All right, we got to stop. Thank you very much, guys, for coming on out and supporting Kinetic Comedy. Give yourselves a round of applause, please. Thank you. Thank you.
Honestly, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Also, everybody that has been watching on the live stream, please make sure you donate. We're raising money for Crisis UK. If you've enjoyed the show, donate as much as you can. Exclamation mark, donate. Tell the people, donate, innit? Tell the people, donate. If
My man should donate some money, you know? My man needs to donate some money now. Get it out, bro.
Definitely donate some. Give it up for all the comedians you saw so far today, guys. You saw Russell Hicks. You saw Johnny Cochrane. You saw Jenny Collier. You saw Aurie Styla. You saw Slim. Give it up for DJ Diamond. Give it up for all the Kinetic crew. Give it up for Marcus, Mama T, Melly, Gelly, Olivia, Kyron, Kate, the whole staff. Thank you very much. We're going to hopefully be doing this again. If you are going home right now, make sure you get home nice and safe. If you're staying to continue to drink and enjoy the vibes, DJ Diamond's going to spin a couple more tracks if you want to vibe some more. But until then, we'll catch you guys next time. Have a lovely one. Thank you. We'll be right back.
this rhythm you have a patch. Yellow man mean it. And you say after me don't mean it, me set it. Zungo zungo go zungo zen. Zungo zungo go zungo zen. Say if you have a paper, you must have a pen. And if you have a start, you must have a end. Say 5 + 5, it equal to 10. And if you have goat, you put them in a pen. And if you have a rooster, you must have a hen. Now zungo zungo go zungo zen. Zungo zungo go zungo zen. Jump for happiness and jump for joy. You know fi call yellow man no boy. Lady and they used to take fit on ya. Brave guy lord him call him child. You know fi call yellow man no boy. You know fi call John John no boy. You know fi take iron knife boy. Zungo zungo go zungo zen. Watch it. Zungo zungo go zungo zen. Catch it. Zungo zungo go zungo zen. Car 00119. Cause yellow man make you feel so fine. Me chat on me lyric, me chat him in a rhyme. Me not eat like me full up a rhyme. Cause yellow man him not commit no crime. Cause zungo zungo go zungo zen. Zungo zungo go zungo zen. Hey, go shung pen, go shung shung pen. Hey, go shung pen, go shung shung pen. Say if you have a start, you must have a end. Say if you have a paper, you pass me the pen. But tell your yellow man I'm too much girlfriend. Can't offer the matter, but me not a no girlfriend. You a idiot, boy, me have a 110. Say all of them, them have yellow children. All of them have yellow children. Some live a Kingston, and don't have me a pen. None of them ask me how me have enough girlfriend. Two arguments, I have enough arguments, Lord. Arguments, I have enough arguments. Me enter in the house of parliament. Prime Minister and his wife have to keep silent. A true yellow man, a chat intelligent. They put me in the court, the judge say you're innocent. Two arguments, I have enough arguments. Sanja should have been my girlfriend. Hey, lady Anne should have been my girlfriend. Make up.